Donkey Kong Country is truly perfect. If you do not get this amazing new generation of Donkey Kong madness, you are stupid. Yes, I know, that's insulting, but it's also the truth. If you're...
Thank you. Thank you for the intro, Navigator.
Ed Wood, best game review journalist of the 1990s.
Hey, we're playing Donkey Kong Country.
Yeah, that this was actually a really good game. I love this game.
The opening with that, as well as...
As well as
the title of the Twitch stream, which you YouTubers won't see, was Jack's idea.
For those of you who are watching this on YouTube, the stream title was, Donkey Kong Country is the greatest platformer of all time.
And if you don't agree, then you are stupid!
Oh, I'm excited to play this game.
And you make some good points. This was some tech for the era.
Yeah. I mean, it's got a unique look and style.
Well, even more than that, this was,
This also, apparently, a lot of speedrunners really love running this game.
I would imagine. I mean, this pushed the, Super NES.
What was that all about?
I must have had it. I told you, we played this before. Oh, you said we didn't.
Huh, okay.
We played this ROM version. We started it, not on stream, but...
Just, like...
And we're playing two-player team.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. You were supposed to be first player.
Was I?
Yeah.
Why?
Because you're Donkey. I'm Diddy. You like Donkey better, right?
I don't care.
I like Diddy better.
Okay, well then switch it.
Okay. Technical difficulties can never be avoided. Oh. All right, player one, you go.
Okay, up, down, left, right, start, select.
This is part of the speed run. Setting our controls.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, now we're going. We're good. Let's do it.
Go for it.
Yeah, I'm doing it. Congo Jungle. What the fuck? Why? We're not doing contest! Why you got those numbers there?
I guess we gotta see who's beaten the most levels. I've never seen those before.
Alright, whatever.
Like, I knew it kept track of who cleared the level, but...
Oh no, we lost our bananas. Better go get them!
And I want to make this 100% run, because this game's actually pretty easy to 100%.
Nah, I it's not like we're racing, so it's fine. Life. The standard tricks of the trade for running this game.
And then you start select, and you re-enter the level, and you spam lives!
Yes. You know,
yo!
If you want to be a dick about it, I'll let you take points.
You Donkey, my man! Which is weird, because I play Donkey Kong in Smash, and you play Diddy Kong.
Yeah, but you love the big, like, the smaller guy more than me loving the big guy.
Well, it's, like, maneuverability is important. This is a platformer.
Yeah. Well, I mean, this game just plays really well.
It does,
like,
yeah.
I play Mario, and Mario has its own unique...
feel?
Yeah, but this game, it's just monkeys doing parkour. It's really good.
Yeah.
And also, you can ride more than one animal,
You can't turn into the animals.
The music is really good.
It is. It was amazing music for the Super NES. It still holds up, would say.
Yeah. Ong! Ong, oing bak!
Ong.
Alright.
That's M. Night's name for Aang.
Ong. I'm not... Okay. Let's keep it on topic this time.
Why?
Wait.
You keep saying that, but there have been a billion streamers who played this game, and I'm sure every one of them have been talking about this game in their stream.
Alright, fine, let's talk about Avatar, then.
I mean, we can talk about everything. I don't care. We can talk about Donkey Kong, we can talk about Avatar, we can talk about porn, I don't care.
God.
Let's talk about Donkey Kong porn.
Let's not.
Okay. Good. That's probably a good idea.
Ong. Oing. Ong.
You can tell you 100% at a level because of the exclamation point.
Yes. Alright.
Tag out trick!
Oh, what? I have to do it?
I mean, you
don't.
Keep
in mind, I don't remember where every secret is.
Yeah, that's true. I can. I'll yell at you.
Okay.
Otherwise, what? You just want me to play the whole game?
No. I actually wanna. No. I guess not up there. TNT. Where's the,
There's no secrets here.
Okay. Okay, so there's a trick in this game. You just roll off and then you get another jump.
Yeah.
Which is really good. I guess that's the thing that Donkey has over Diddy, is that he can hit things better.
Well, yeah, he's stronger. He can...
Yeah.
The stronger enemies Donkey can take out and Diddy can't.
Okay.
or Donkey can hit them with,
Alright, nothing down here.
Stronger attacks.
Coming up on anything?
I'll let you know when I see it.
Okay. You better.
Go back.
Go back?
Down left, and go between those trees.
These trees?
Yeah.
Just jump down?
Yep.
Okay.
That's a dick one.
Yeah! No, I would never have gotten that one. Alright. My OCD is kicking in.
Must collect every banana!
No, I don't have OCD. Yeah, it's just... Shinies! How could I not collect them? Yeah. We don't actually need to complete this level, right? That's...
I mean, we need to... I think we need to get to the end. I'm not sure if it counts as just entering the secret is acquiring it.
Alright, we'll take no chances then. Okay. We're here now.
Yeah, that's the right size of bees proportional to gorillas.
Well, that's because these bees are
these are species. African bees.
Africanized killer bees.
You remember that craze?
The craze of getting attacked by Africanized killer bees. Man, have you been attacked by killer bees? Yeah, that's all the rage! Alright, I guess I can't get these things, whatever they are, so I'm gonna have to go forward.
No, it was like a rhino or something.
Oh shit, I'm way out of I got a bad pattern. Okay, good.
I'm tempted to just avoid the animals because they're just kind of time sinks.
Ow, sorry. Yeah, that was a really bad pattern. What, only one secret?
I think so.
And uh-oh. Now it's daytime.
Fuck off.
Might as well get the Jeep.
The kids on my bus, the primary schoolers, keep asking me to do, SpongeBob voices, and I can only do Squidward, really. SpongeBob is too high for me.
Yeah, I can't. I don't trust anybody other than the guy.
Oh, no, we did miss one. Huh.
Alright, we better go back, Finn. Shit. So, I guess the lizard people, huh? That's what this,
Crocodiles.
Yeah, crocodiles. And they're captained by, like, a king pirate.
Yeah.
K. Rule.
For Smash 5. Pretty please, Sakurai.
Just give him a blunderbuster already. Fuck it.
Oh, I wonder if I needed that barrel.
Problem?
I don't think there'd be a secret there, but I'm not positive.
This game... Okay, here's the thing about this game as compared to Donkey Kong Country 2.
The secrets aren't obvious.
Not only are they not obvious, they actually have secrets within secrets.
Oh yeah, that's
which is fucking insane!
It is, very much so.
Like, that's the kind of thing where it's like, you show me that one time, and I'm like, you've gotta be fucking kidding me! Maybe see on the other side.
No, I don't think there's anything here.
Yeah, well... You don't think there's anything here, but we're obviously missing something. Maybe it's in the sky?
It's not here.
Okay.
There may have been something where where those barrels were before, but I'm not positive, so let's just keep going.
Alright. Attempt two.
Until muscle memory kicks in. Okay. You missed it again.
I did?
Yeah.
The secret?
Maybe that's the secret. That's the you have to jump from the rope onto that patch to get the tire.
Okay. Let me see if
here,
I can.
Here, see if you can. No, you can't.
I mean, that was a good attempt, you gotta admit.
Sure. I was gonna say something you could have done, but well, that works too.
Okay, you're... What could I have done?
You could have jumped up onto the bee at its highest point, which would give me control, and I might have been able to, from my jump, be high enough to do it.
Oh, that would have worked. My apologies for not getting that.
You fucked up the speed man, man! Speed run, man!
Oh, tire! Yeah, and then... Jump on that, and that's a froggy. Oh no, you lost the tire!
Uh-oh.
Maybe that's up on the up there. Maybe that's what.
Maybe.
No, it can't be.
Well, I guess we're not gonna know now for this life.
Lives are plentiful in this game.
They are. We're gonna have, like, many lives. Yeah. Bitch, be gon' trippin' lives.
If we get a game over, we suck. We still haven't gotten it, so... But we got another life, so that's good. Can you make... Oh!
What was that?
That was a barrel down. There's apparently some kind of, like...
Oh, wait, wait.
Oh! Yeah! Oh, my God!
At least it was visible, if barely so.
It's raining again!
da 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 da.
Yeah, there you go. I was gonna say far right, so you actually made the correct choice.
It appears on the last one for like one frame.
So these monkeys, are they like, they're basically hillbillies, right?
I guess, yeah. Jungle hillbillies.
Just like
savages.
The savage. Wait,
that was.
Yeah, we
yeah,
got it.
Complete.
Good.
Okay.
All right. Now we go to
Reptile Rumble.
All right.
Oh, tag out. So no, I was saying that I can't do SpongeBob voices, but so in their place, they're asking me to do Shrek voices.
Oh, damn it!
Which I can do a few of. So that's something, I guess.
Oh, I remember. Good.
Just take a barrel into every wall that might have something in your hood.
You gotta give him some more Kurosuchi voices or something. Like, you gotta...
They're not gonna know Kurosuchi.
But they're gonna hear the voice and they're gonna be like, oh, that's a pretty cool voice. What is that? Ah, shit. So I get for trying to be overconfident.
Oh, right, it's me.
Yeah.
I'm glad it does that instead of just giving control immediately.
No, that would suck. This game is really well designed. You can come back for me. Or not.
There's
Thank
a
you.
Secret here. I would have lost the barrel anyway.
Remember life! Succeed! I think the speedrun of this game did it in like 102%. It did like in an hour
yeah.
and a half. So, yeah, if you're optimistic about it being 3 hours, then that's actually, you got plenty of wiggle room there.
I think we can do it.
Yeah. This is not a speedrun, this is just us playing a game for fun.
Oh, okay.
Nice! Trick shot!
Alright. There's a high school girl on my bus.
Uh-huh.
Who was,
Go on! that's a great way to begin it! Don't... Just be...
This isn't... That, don't start acting like that!
Yeah, okay. Go on, I'm just yanking her chain. Go on.
She likes to troll people. And she asked me one day if I was her BFF.
I said,
oh my god, totally. I will totally be your BFF.
Jeez.
And she laughed, and the joke's been carried on since.
Nice.
And, One time, she shouted from the back of the bus what my favorite Girl Scout cookie was. And I said, Thin Mints! And then she said that she was like the only person in the world who didn't like Girl Scout cookies. And that she would give me her Girl Scout cookies.
Okay.
So today she brought me a little baggie of Thin Mints.
Okay, good.
And she was also, she also complains a lot about wanting goldfish, like the crackers.
Goldfish?
Yeah.
Okay.
And she was walking off the bus this morning saying, where's my goldfish? You got goldfish for me? Or like, last afternoon or something.
Not a secret.
No. That might count, I'm not sure. I think those do count as the secrets in underwater levels.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Do you have to get those to get the exclamation point?
Yeah, there aren't very many.
Fuck!
But she gets me the bag of Thin Mints today, I'm like, well, shit. So I had to stop at the dollar store and get her goldfish.
Better not let your bosses find out. That could be misconstrued. Like, no, I'm dead serious.
Yeah.
Like, people are really touchy about that shit these days.
Yeah.
Like, even if it's just like, oh, like, yeah, she gave me Thin Mints, I gave her some crackers, people would be like, oh!
What's that a euphemism for?
Nothing! I didn't like goldfish, she didn't like Thin Mints, it was a fucking trade-off!
I actually looked at the nutritional facts. Goldfish are comparatively healthy.
That's why all the schools, like, sell them. I don't like the taste, though. They're all, like, it's like stale cheese and, like,
yeah.
and that's
I like goldfish. Cheez-Its taste like stale cheese to me. you have Cheez-Its?
Hey, you know, it's something I actually prefer, Cheez-Its.
They taste kind of similar. Cheese nips are like stale Cheez-Its.
Cheese nips can go fuck themselves.
There's stuff up. I think it's just a letter.
And a shark. Fuck, shark! What the fuck is a shark doing in fresh water?
Oh, you know, just hanging out, mutating.
I lost my mother. Dies. I'm definitely be
that is actually the junior version of the shark.
Yes. Functionally identical.
Yeah. No?
Hey, it's his brother, Daryl.
Did he can't ride one too? Yeah, on guard and Daryl.
On guard and...
Hey, let's swim together, Daryl!
On guard and Alez. That's what we can do. What's another?
Something to do with sword fighting.
Parry?
Sure. Parry. Nope. That's a good name.
Parry.
Go to the right.
On guard and parry. Alright. Oh! No! That'll take us out of the level.
Well, you got the secret. You're fine. Just go back.
Yeah.
Avoiding the bonus stages.
Yeah, that's an actual speedrun strat,
obviously.
Too. Like, you lose a lot of time doing those.
Yeah. And you can't. There's no way to force exit out of them. You have to wait the timer out.
Yeah, it's dumb.
So this is a speedrun in the sense that we're trying to do this in one sitting.
We're
so
trying
we
to do this under 3 hours.
We don't want to waste time.
EST under 3 hours.
Another life.
And if we don't get it done, then fucking the fucking AGDQ team will be put out, and then they'll ban us for AGDQ.
Yeah.
Which has happened. People have gotten...
It is kind of annoying that it doesn't swap characters after beating a level, only when you die. Because that's how most games work, is you trade after beating a level or die, right?
Yeah.
Because otherwise, if one person is just really good at the game and never dies...
Yeah, they'll hog it. I'm allowing you to... These levels are really fun, because all you need to have is just really good timing.
Don't know if there's something down here.
Nope.
I was trying to cartwheel, not just jump off, but okay.
I guess I'm going.
Guess there's nothing down there. Well, that skips like half the level.
Okay, we don't want to do that.
I don't know if there are
secrets. I want to actually play the game.
I don't know if there are secrets we'll miss doing that.
Exactly. I like seeing the 100% speedruns of the game, because any just random schlub can just go from beginning to end. I want to see a guy go from beginning to end and then just get everything in between.
There was something under there.
Oh, is there? Down here?
You did where the barrel was. I don't think you can get that far back.
I can.
See that frog?
That's what I get for trying to maneuver midair. Go. So underneath the barrel. Wow, you just went deathly silent.
I'm focusing.
Yeah, I just displeased you that much.
Huh. So there has to be something down where I fell.
I don't know. Maybe here.
I don't think it counts as a secret, but there has to be a way to get that frog down.
It's just there to just taunt you, just to fuck with you. So those barrels they're supposed to be cannons, right?
Yeah.
It's weird. Like. You know Gilligan's Island with its fucking bamboo technology, right?
Yeah.
Like, got the professor who built, like, a bunch of shit out of bamboo. He built a working television out of nothing but, like, whatever he found on the island. That's what this is reminding me of. Like, they managed to make working cannons out of nothing but, like, wood.
Donkey Kong Country is actually Gilligan's Island.
They're on an island!
Yeah.
I mean... If you're gonna be attacked by pirates, you gotta have something good to defend yourself.
Ready for a dumb one? Whee!
Trust fall. I remember this one.
Fuck it all! Speedrun.
Fire everything!
There we go. Fuck the system. Fuck your game. I'm playing my game.
Alright, second one. What's this one? Oh, shoot. It's basically Pachinko.
Nope.
No, it's not.
Don't
need
that.
Why did I say that? How many secrets are here? Two or three?
I think those were the only ones, okay. But I want to be safe. I know there's one that's a dick one. I don't think it's on this level.
You're not talking about the,
I'm talking about there's like a level that ends in a giant mountain and you have to carry a barrel over the mountain avoiding enemies to the other side where the secret is.
Oh god, that sounds like pain. It's just so much fun just seeing your player just ricochet.
Yeah.
Everywhere.
Without getting stuck in a ball form.
Yeah. If anything, Sonic is more Donkey Kong is more comparable to Sonic than Mario is. Mario is a precision kind of guy, whereas the monkeys just like to traverse just quickly.
I guess. I mean, Mario games are also designed so you never have to stop running. That's what makes them, you know, fun.
Oh, really?
Well, yeah, that's what... You've never noticed that in Mario games?
I think you have to stop plenty of times.
In the 2D platformers.
Oh. I guess.
Not talking about the 3D ones. Because 3D Mario games and 2D Mario games are totally different beasts.
Yeah, I know.
Much like 2D and 3D Sonic games.
Yeah, it's... Super Mario 64 is all about precision. I would say the same thing about Super Mario World, because if you aren't, like, really precise with your jumps, I can't imagine doing that game without, like, stopping.
But it's not about precision platforming, stopping and studying your movements and where you're gonna go next.
Yeah, I guess you got a point there. You know, I'll have to stop. Okay.
It's not, well... Spelunky's kind of a middle ground. You do get punished for rushing without looking ahead.
Yeah.
But it is a very fluid game where you don't have to stop moving.
Yeah, but there's also... don't have to. God. You know, they have, like... You know those runner games they had for, What?! Are you serious?! Fuck it.
That works. For what?
Oh, shit, what was I talking about?
Runner games.
Oh, yeah, those cell phone games where it's like you're constantly like, running and you have to like tap the screen.
Oh, that, to, like, yeah.
Yeah, they released a Mario version of it and it sucked.
Was that what that game was?
Well, Super Mario Run, yeah.
I know everyone was talking about it. I didn't know that was what it was. Just the same thing that people have done 100 times over.
Whatever, we can refresh it. Yeah. Oh, shit!
Go get him, Espresso!
I care so little, I'm in the kitchen getting Dr. Pepper.
Yeah. Dr. Pepper? Oh yeah, we both have Dr. Pepper today.
I have a diet.
Alright. Minute left.
Oh, you got the thing early?
Yeah. Fuck it. Oh, I spilled some all over myself. I'm out of here! Jumps off screen. It's a game over.
Yeah.
Yeah, these ones are a waste of time, because this game is really generous with lives.
I like these fake seconds it's using, by the way.
Yeah, not quite seconds.
Oh, no! We only get 3 lives! Well, 2 lives.
Yeah, 2 lives. It's fine.
And that's what was fun about these old NES and Super NES games, was that it was largely just a matter of, you know, testing your skill in platforming to get to the end of the game, but the secret hunting was the exploration aspect.
Yeah. You're good. I'm missing a secret. I'm good.
I'll let you know.
Was that the only one?
I guess so.
We'll see. Yep, that was the only one. Good.
Oh boy, it's your favorite level!
Fuck. I'm glad you're doing this!
Yeah. Uh-uh.
Are you no, fuck you, you're doing it!
I don't mind. This is actually my favorite level, I think.
Well, good.
It was my favorite level as a kid. Which is funny because it is basically one of those jumping games.
So,
So, Super Donkey Kong Jump, guys!
Okay, so, So, funny story, when we were in Job Corps, that's where I met Xelrog.
Yeah.
We decided to, like, this is for the streamers and whoever's listening, by the way.
Yeah.
We decided, in order to kill time when we were not having classes, we were going to, just play SNES games. You owned SNES, and at some point, one of us got a small TV? I think it was you?
I don't remember. We had a few small TVs. They were pretty abundant.
Yeah.
People got rid of a lot of them.
Yeah, they were perfect because they were small enough that you could just fit it in wherever you needed it to be, and then...
So we just brought him into the laundry room with us whenever we did, laundry.
Oh, God damn it! Alright. So yeah, we brought him into the laundry room with us and just played some Donkey Kong. Damn it. I hate those things coming at us the other side.
I thought we were in, like, our room when it, with what you're talking about happened, though.
No, we were in the laundry room. So I was at the time we were playing contest, and you were like dominating the lead, and I was in the minecart level, and I was focusing super hard, and then you just said
jump,
and I just reflexed, hit jump, and I careened into one like
you landed on a minecart.
Yes.
Regained control of your second Kong, who landed in the minecart, and it did the little auto bounce thing.
What the fuck?
It did the little auto bounce thing and landed on another minecart.
And then
so no input. No input you could have made would have changed the death. You instantly lost two Kongs from where I told you to jump.
You killed me that day.
I did.
And then at a later point, I hit the table in frustration, and then the screen went dark because we were using a physical console.
Yeah.
And then you just turned to me for a second, and you said, jump!
Did I?
To mock me, yeah. But then you looked and you're like, you broke it! Fortunately, I didn't, but we had to go back and save, I think.
Oh, yeah.
So I guess this level doesn't have any secrets.
Nope.
That minecart must be heavy. How do you think? They're just like,
I mean, Donkey DK's pretty strong.
What about Diddy? What's his excuse?
Oh, I don't know. Monkey aerobics.
You would have.
That's the most fun guy to get killed by. The guy right in front of the exit.
That's there, what we call a Kaizo trap.
Bouncy Bonanza!
Oh, yes.
No.
Also, the bees kind of turn green at certain points.
Yeah, I think it depends on the level and its lighting.
Is it there? Nope.
I don't think there are any around here. I remember doing this many times.
Oh, I'm up.
And never finding anything, but it's just a force of habit to check every spot.
Yeah,
I think down there there might be one on the left.
On the left? Alright. Oh god, this is gonna be difficult.
If you hold down and release it, you can set it down and then swap to me if you like. That also works.
Yeah. I don't think so.
Here, swap.
Okay. Yeah, no. There we go!
Oh, there's one.
Oh. Okay.
This is a match all three game.
Yeah, I know.
We don't need lives, but everything else is even more worthless.
Ah! Shakes his head in shame. Timing is not my strong point for some reason.
You know how the graphics for this game were done, right?
They told me. The review that we watched in the very beginning mentioned it. It was like silicon graphics.
It was photographs of clay figurines.
Yes. The same method that Mortal Kombat used.
Yeah.
Except Mortal Kombat did it with actual people.
Yeah.
It also, that's the same method that, for some reason, Dong Dong Never Die uses.
Dong Dong Never Die.
We gotta play that someday. That's an amazing fighting game. Whoa. Is that a secret?
No, I don't. Maybe it's supposed to be. Cone.
Cone. What?
Cone. Fox. Best Ursa Insura character.
he's the nicest one. He's just a cute little fox.
Yeah.
Up there?
Yeah, it's a Winky. Winky!
That counts as a secret?
I don't know. I don't know what that little thing up there is. I think it must be the lives thing.
Yeah, it is.
Hiding behind
because the foreground blocks out everything.
But then it disappears after a second or so.
Yeah. Every time you enter a level, it shows you how many lives you got left.
Oh, okay.
Because this game is well designed.
Yeah.
Like, I like Lagoon, but I'll talk a lot of shit about it because that's not a well-designed game. I'm not gonna talk shit about this game.
Yeah.
Except in times when I'm losing, then I might say, fuck this game. But I don't actually give a shit. Hope I didn't need him.
I don't think so. I think there's a secret in the end that we can access either with Winky or with a tire that they'll give us.
Okay. Shit. Okay. Plus, I'm actually competent at this game.
Yeah.
Unlike other games where I just am hopeless. I say as I die.
Here it is. walk, not run.
Yeah. Oh, that's the one. Oh, fuck. Actual challenge. In my Donkey Kong game?
It's more likely than you might believe.
Spinning!
This world makes no fucking sense. It's like, go to... They went to the zoo and looked at the gorilla enclosure. Tires, bananas. Let's make a game!
Let's make a level based off of out of an enclosure.
But what are the bad guys gonna be? I don't see any crocodiles in this cage. Crocodiles and gorillas must be enemies. Sound logic, Iwata-san.
Crocodiles and gorillas, natural enemies.
Yeah, they
fight
all
the... One's from Africa, one's from Florida.
They fight all the time in them African jungles.
I wonder if there's actual footage observed of just a gorilla taking a crocodile to task.
Yeah.
For that matter, them fighting wasps.
I think the gorilla would win.
No shit, the gorilla would win!
Gorillas aren't to be fucked with.
No, you don't fuck with gorillas! Like, yeah, they look like cute, like, little monk, like, cute monkeys, but they'll fuck you up!
Alright.
Oh!
Whatever.
Yeah! What is it in the... In the second game, I'm trying to think of who else the enemies were. They added, like, vultures to their,
There are vultures in this.
Oh, okay. This weird-ass animal alliance of, vultures...
And crocodiles.
Yeah.
And evil orangutans. You've got the anti-Kong clan in this one. For, like, one level.
Yeah. They toss barrels at you, and you're supposed to just sit there and take it.
I never played this level all the way through as a...
Oh, you always used the warp?
Always. There was no reason not to.
All right, I'll take over. We did. All right, I'm guessing we took care of all the...
Yeah, I think I got all the secrets. Okay. There were only the two.
Then I'll just keep going then.
They threw some pretty tricky levels into the early world of this game.
Yeah. And the warp... Okay, one of my least favorite worlds in this game is the fucking factory level, because those levels are dick hard.
Now, are you talking about the one with, like, the...
Oil barrels? Yeah, yeah.
Okay. I think...
Oh, wait. Okay, I know what I have to do. Yeah, I got it!
I think my least favorite either has to be the,
Damn it! That was awesome!
The mines, where they have all of the... Like the level where you have to stand on a platform and refuel it constantly.
Oh, yeah?
Shit like that. Or the ice level. Ice world.
Oh, because of the slickness.
No, just...
Boring?
Difficult platforming in the snow levels.
Yeah, because it's slick. Alright, Aztec level!
No, the snow parts weren't slick.
Were they not?
No, only the ice, which is like indoor caves.
Huh. Oh, well. So much for the K. At least we got a secret down. Oh, wait! You're supposed to be playing now.
Man, come on, I don't care. It didn't give me... I guess only if you get hit.
Okay. Good one, Donkey Kong! Just... Look at those goobers. What?
There's an infinite lives trick if you're a Diddy and you jump on those guys, so you keep bouncing off of them at that angle there. I was trying it. I was not successful.
No, you weren't. Can I take these guys out?
No.
No.
That would make sense, but no, there was a barrel down there. Oh, it's just, not a secret.
Yo, you fell here. Oh, wait. I fucked up.
Good job, MacGyver!
I wasn't expecting that shit! Oh. Millstone.
Oh, that's, you needed the tire.
Oh, I did for a secret?
Yeah, it's above the guy there, see it?
Okay. Yeah. it was worth a shot.
If only this game had throwable partners. The best feature of the sequel.
Oh, God. Yeah, second game is like the first game, except better. And I don't know, I don't care what you say, I like the third game
too. I know you do. Did you not break out?
No. Okay. Apparently I didn't.
Oh, well.
That was weird.
I guess Diddy's going solo.
You better not die, because I'm not there to back you up. There you go. Da, da, da,
da, da, da. Yeah, at least...
Rare!
Rare. At least for quite a while in...
Oh, no!
In games.
Yeah.
If plot, like, mascot platformer specifically, I feel like there was a trend of, the first game being not quite ambitious enough, the second game being just right, and the third game being too ambitious. Like, I think that was the case with Crash Bandicoot, with Spyro. I've heard that about Sly Cooper.
Third game being too ambitious?
Yeah.
Well...
I would say, you know, kind of a similar argument with Donkey Kong.
I'd say that Watch Dogs is following that trend, because the first game did very little, and then the second game, most people were felt like it was just right. I can't wait for them to come out with the third game in which it's too ambitious.
Yeah.
I want to see how a too ambitious ambitious Watch Dogs would be, how that would be.
Too many playable characters.
I guess Grand Theft Auto 5.
For some people, they would say the same thing about Sonic the Hedgehog, because 3 had all the different playable characters.
It had Sonic.
Tails, Knuckles.
Yeah.
And Sonic and Tails.
It was fine. I mean, I hate it when people complain about, oh, we got options.
Yeah.
I love options. People love options. But working at the pizza place I worked at, the reason why we're getting as much business as we are getting is because people love options.
Yeah.
All right.
The thing is, though, in a lot of these games, and especially this was my major complaint with Spyro 3, is that the levels where you have to play as characters other than Spyro are not optional. They're full levels that are just by themselves. So if you want 100% the game, you have to do them.
Yeah. That makes sense. That would be a complaint. I mean, the option to play as a different character would be fine. Don't force me to play as a different character.
Yeah. Right? And that was also... Sly 2 had the good... had the good balance of you being able to play as all three characters rather than just Sly the whole game.
Yeah.
Whereas, I think they added, like, a bunch more varied levels. You play as Carmelita a lot in Sly 3.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Doing what?
I don't know. Shooting stuff? Gunplay?
I mean, I like a little gunplay, but she wouldn't work with Sly. That's the whole thing! She's a cop!
I mean, I'm sure there's story reason for it. We finished Sly 2, didn't we?
Yeah, we played Sly 2, and then at the very end, I know how that ends. A very, very whiplashy ending where it was like, oh no, this has happened. Anyway, let's go on a nice dinner.
We're good.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, have a frog.
All right.
Hello, new teammate.
Hello. So much for that. Do we need him?
I don't think so.
Okay.
Coconuts! I think that's what they are. Fuck if I know.
I shouldn't have just dived in there.
No, we still don't have all the secrets.
Wow, this level's kicking our ass. I'm doing as well as you are right now, I feel.
Yeah?
You don't agree?
No, I mean, you're doing as well as I am gameplay-wise. I just have the secrets knowledge.
Yeah, secrets are kind of... Fuck, I love Lucian and Gaia, and I don't even remember where all the secrets in that game are. Let's just get off and then...
I was trying to remember how to get off, or if you could get off.
There's a button X.
Jack, how do I get off?
You hit select.
Can you help me get off?
Trust me when I say you don't pay me that much.
I don't pay you.
Exactly!
You're waiting for that, huh?
Alright, got this big-ass grin on my face, I'm just glad we-
Oh,
man!
But where's the secret?
I don't think there is one.
There has to be.
No, like, there- What makes you so sure?
Is it didn't have the exclamation point yet. Now okay, you have to beat the level before it shows up.
So we went. I feel like we've had this discussion before.
Maybe. Nope. Oh,
so
yeah,
by the way, the bosses in this game are kind of lame.
Yeah.
It's just like
two had better bosses.
Way better. And three had some pretty clever bosses too. There we go, we got him.
All for you, man! You beat him! Yeah!
Shut up! Don't patronize me.
I wonder if you probably get the win now.
Yeah, yep. You handed me the win. Good job. Alright, Vulture Culture! Oh yeah, I love this track.
Yeah.
Ah!
Maybe the vultures just want, like, ownership of the island. That's why they're working with the Kremlings.
They want the Kremlings promised them.
Whatever
them,
the fuck
like,
the Kremlings want. They just like
they're
bananas.
Pirates! They want gold!
Bananas? There's no gold here!
Maybe the bananas are golden. That's the secret.
Oh. Don't!
What, don't push it off?
Yeah, because now you can't get that thing on the side there, see? The left, the grass patch. There it is.
Fortunately.
Your other left, Jack.
Well, there's a grass patch there. Whatever.
No, there wasn't.
Oh, I was talking about this thing. I'm like,
that's
wait.
In the background. That's not on the ground. The
stoppable. I have no excuse. I'm wearing my glasses.
Stoppable spots are pretty obvious in this game.
Alright. We still haven't found any secrets yet. Ah!
Thank you, Barrel. Once again, you've saved me. Donkey can do the ground pound.
Oh,
I don't,
yeah,
I don't know if that works on those stompable places or not.
It works whenever it wants to.
That doesn't
work. Alright, so, oh no, we've only got 34 lives left.
What will we do now?
Like, seriously, there's just... Okay. Those neckies are just really small.
They're junior neckies.
Necky twos.
This game is actually all about necking.
Show off your neck. Your neck is a border town.
To the Amish it is.
Really?
No.
This is what Amish actually believe.
That was, I think that was in like the Amish Paradise music video. There were two teenage Amish boys looking at like a porn magazine. It was just a girl lifting her dress up to her ankle.
Of course there was. Alright, I found it. Oh, this one.
They're spitting gold!
Sorry about that.
Yeah, whatever. We really needed the lives, man. How could you?
Alrighty.
My barrel umbrella will protect me.
Oh, I guess it's not useful anymore. Alright. So this is basically a cannon level.
Yep.
Except it's got a weird layout.
So who manufactures these barrels?
Presumably the Kongs.
You think so?
Yeah, they're like super good,
They're a barrel making family? That's their, family?
Yeah, Cranky Kong built them.
Yeah, their family, trade.
Yeah, after the Kongs made their peace with the Mushroom Kingdom, they decided, you know what, we should manufacture barrel tech.
Yeah.
I mean, Mushroom Kingdom has pipe tech. Yeah, you're dead.
You know what's weird? You talked about the Mushroom Kingdom and I already want to play Paper Mario again. Oh, right, I gotta start grinding in that.
Yeah. You said you were going to.
Yeah. Well, I haven't had any time, man.
Wow, I remembered where those two secrets were.
Yeah.
Ow! Dang it.
Yay!
Damn it!
I did it! Oh, we still missed one.
Did we? Three secrets. I don't know where the third one is. Not there, I checked.
Diddy Kong, the silent killer.
Silencer barrel.
I get it.
Yeah, nuclear barrel that just has the fucking nuclear symbol on it.
Wait, I have an idea.
Oh, you do? I love those. Oh, you don't think? Damn it! Of course. K O N G.
Kong.
Kong.
Stop giving us those. We don't need them.
They're a waste of time, and they fuck up our level. They fuck up our progress.
If only this game had inventory management, so we could throw out our. Can I do this? Yes, I can.
Good job.
Speedrun tricks.
Oh, this level format is I really like because it's just the Kong's fucking with a bunch of like treetop people.
Yeah. That was the best level in Spyro too. You remember that?
Yeah. How could I forget? Extra life! Yay! Gotta wait for you to fuck up so we can,
You wanna fuck with the treetop people? I remember this level having some bullshit secrets, though.
Okay,
and damn it.
Damn it! Alright!
As I say, I die. Just keep going.
Alright, just call them out to me.
Will do. Oh, you missed one! No, I'm kidding. Jump!
We're on a team! Don't fuck with me!
I know. Last time we played this, we were versus.
Damn it!
And you were just trying to get to the end of the game, and I was 100% trying to 100% it.
And you ended up beating me anyway!
It was close, though.
Yeah. Close, I guess.
We were both fighting K. Rool at the same time. I beat him first.
Yeah.
Some cool floating donkey did there for a second.
K. Rool is nothing to fuck with. He's actually a competent, like, fighter. Although...
He's a big motherfucker when you consider how big Donkey is in Smash.
And you know something else? I don't know what K. Rool's, like, plans are.
Exactly.
What he has in-game. He's got as much, like, fucking in-game as Xana.
I mean, I guess Xana wants to be evil. He wants to rule the world. I think.
What does King Rule want? Just go all the gold.
Yeah, he's a pirate. Except there's no gold here, so it kind of falls flat.
No, they're probably... Oh, that one. Oh, fuck that. And...
Done.
That was lucky for you. Just what? Oh! Are you serious? Okay.
Okay, I didn't know if that was a secret or if it was just a savior barrel. I remember there was one down there, so that was kind of nice of them.
Yeah. This has just become really tense.
Barrels! Barrels are fun. I get it.
Oh, God.
That had to be on the in the game's advertisement, right?
Barrels of fun?
Yeah.
It almost would have to be. More fun than a barrel of monkeys! Meanwhile, some advertising exec just dives out the window.
Yay, we did it.
5-9. I can't believe they're keeping score. I would really prefer them not to keep score.
Yeah.
Alright, can you switch?
Fine.
You're not why?!
I'll switch.
We agreed, right? You fucker!
Oh, you made it! Good job!
Why are you being a dick to me? We're on the same team!
I'll stop.
Please!
It's just a joke, man. It's just a joke, bro!
It's just a prank, bro!
Why are you getting mad, bro?
I hate those fucking people. Those people who are, like, deciding to fuck with people in a very real way, and then they reasonably get angry, and they're like, it's just a prank, bro! It's just a prank!
Yeah.
Okay. Ah, damn it. Fuck it.
It also has lots of animations.
Yeah. Okay.
I think I would apply that formula I mentioned earlier to... What? Did you just miss?
Yeah, it seems like it.
Can you stomp it?
No.
No. Can you get back on the rope?
What the fuck? Yeah, there we go!
Okay, that works.
K.
Can you?
But it's just a DK barrel, so.
Yeah, I don't think it's.
Yeah.
They don't usually put DK barrels next to. That you're used to. You're meant to break on things.
Yeah.
But I think that formula would also apply to Crash Bandicoot, because while Crash Warped is a terrific game, I don't enjoy it quite as much as 2, because there are just so many different types of levels.
Yeah.
Like, you got the plane levels. You got, you know, the boss where he's shooting a gun at Engine. And just, after a point, I just wish more of the levels were just, you know, plain old Crash platforming.
Yeah.
And the water levels. The water levels sucked in that game.
The reason why Donkey Kong... Oh, shit. The reason why Donkey Kong is so good is because most of it, like, a great majority of it is, like, platforming levels, but they do different gimmicks with them. Especially in 2 and 3. They really change up, like, what the hat level hazards are and stuff.
Yeah. From what I played at 3, it felt like one of those too many gimmick games for me.
Oh. Well,
I'm gonna give it a chance. We're gonna get through it. At some point after we finish this one, we'll do 2 and then 3, obviously.
Yeah, of course.
And then Donkey Kong 64, the 80-part stream!
No, we're not doing that. If we can't do Banjo-Kazooie, we definitely can't do that. Because that's Banjo-Kazooie on crack!
I like how, I like how the people who grew up playing Donkey Kong 64 still like to go back to the game, acknowledging that it's a collect-a-thon. But, that said, Nintendo has never tried 3D Donkey Kong again.
No. Well...
All the new games have been 2D.
Yeah, Tropical Freeze and stuff, yeah. It's basically been... Are there no secrets in this level?
There are some. When you see a little banana at the bottom, there's a barrel immediately underneath it.
Alright, I'll have to stay near the bottom then. No?
Must be later.
Hope so.
Oh god, switch to me. Or set it down. This is the part.
I'll clear out the Kremlins first.
It'll disappear. Switch to me. If you leave the barrel,
let me finish the level at least.
Okay. Yeah, if you leave the barrel, it'll disappear and be gone forever.
I wasn't going to. I was just going to kill him once and... Maybe I'll throw on the left side? No? Okay, there we go.
Yeah, that's a pain. That
no,
one.
It seems like... Oh, no!
Nope.
I guess that's...
That's it. I think. Hopefully.
No.
Oh.
Yeah, okay.
Maybe that banana was one was on that level and we just weren't paying attention.
Probably not. We'll find out. So, the beginning levels are like jungle stuff, and then we're here and it's this Pacific Northwest, like pine trees and shit.
Yeah.
So we got one rainforest and we got the other rainforest.
Yeah.
It's great. They didn't do a desert level in this game.
No.
I guess it wouldn't make sense.
As opposed to that blizzard world that makes perfect sense.
This is snow. It's like mountaintops. Of course it makes sense. It's like, oh, you're so high up that the hills are covered in snow.
Then you go higher up and you're at a factory.
Yeah, and global warming is, like, preventing it from, like,
This is actually a very long journey, taking over the course of a year, of trying to get the Kremlings off his blasted island.
We're gonna go to the factory, we gotta blow it up, then we're gonna go to the ship, and we're gonna fuck with that.
We gotta go to the factory and do a return to the past.
Then we'll go...
What the fuck was that factory?
It made cars, I think.
Oh, yeah. Well, no, that was the real world factory that it was based off of. We never found out what the actual Lyoko factory did.
I presume it's like experiments with like quantum mechanics and shit.
Had to be robots, because Xana was building robots there, right?
Yeah, well, and he was virtualizing robots with that... No,
he also built a robot physically on an assembly line once.
Oh, yeah, you're right about that.
Because remember that Code Lyoko takes place in Ghetto Cyberpunk Land.
Ghetto Cyberpunk France, California.
Yeah, where it's in a cyberpunk world, but it's the shitty part of a cyberpunk world that can only afford the technology from 10 years ago.
Yeah.
Okay, I think I know where it is.
You do?
It was on that rope, but there is no banana. So you just have to hang as low as possible and your hitbox collides with it. So just die. Kill yourself, bro.
Kill yourself. I'll give you one chance. Kill yourself.
Would have been cool if you had made it that jump to it, but
I want to see a villain say that to like a hero, even when he's on the ropes. It's like, all right, I'm gonna give you one chance. Kill yourself.
What was that from?
I just made it up.
Oh,
very low. Remember?
I know it's during the buzzards part though.
Okay.
And there's probably some signal as to where, which part of the buzzard's pattern it happens with, but...
A signal, huh?
I don't know that I could recognize that at a glance. If we watch the bottom of the screen really closely, maybe we'll see, like, the tippy top of the barrel.
I'm staring at it.
When the vultures start happening.
Yeah.
Vulture culture.
Vulture culture. I hear that, I'm, like, thinking...
Oh.
Alright, it's up to me, then.
Yep.
We don't have to kill ourselves, we can just...
Watch the bottom. Down.
Oh, there it is. I see it.
Oh, you saw it?
Yeah.
Oh, I see it. Oh, God damn it. That's like 5 pixels. That's like 25 pixels high.
Yeah.
Or something. That's really tiny.
And it blends in with the brown background.
God, that sucks.
Nintendo hard.
You want to get all the secrets? Pay attention, dumbass.
I'm pretty sure there's a mission in Maple Story, one of the random quest lines, that you're supposed to, like, it's one of those identify the difference games.
Uh-huh.
Where you have, like, 10 objects and one of them is slightly different.
Slightly.
And you're supposed to identify that one and destroy it. But I'm pretty sure in the American version of the game, or the worldwide version,
uh-huh.
As in not the original Korean one.
They
use the same sprites for all of them, so there's no difference.
So it's just a guessing game.
Yes, it's a game with
God!
Totally defeats the purpose. It is such a bugged piece of crap, Maple Story. Yeah, I did that on purpose.
And yet you still play it.
Yeah, I do. I hate myself for it.
Guilty pleasure.
I could have just... Actually, yeah, never mind. I'll go through.
Yeah.
I forgot that... Did they change that in the second game, that if you finish a level, it swaps?
I don't know. You better swap, though.
All right.
Or not.
Jump. Oh, I thought that was a barrel
set. Okay, good news. It's not going to be that big a setback.
Yeah. Da 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 da. Hope you don't get tired of this music.
At least it's not like dun 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 dun.
You know, they decided to use the evolution music for background music. Cause why not? We've got it in the game, right? We don't have any resources.
You designed a thing for. Did you remember to design a thing for
the Safari Zone?
The Safari Zone. Oh, about that. God damn it.
What about Nugget Bridge? No? Okay, we'll just use the Professor Oak music. It'll be fine.
Snugget Bridge. I guess that's the proper name for it, considering.
There's a spot in Sun Moon where there are 5 trainers.
Uh-huh.
Who have the same party and Pokemon as the Nugget Bridge. They're role-playing as the Nugget Bridge trainers.
They explicitly state, we're the Nugget Bridge trainers!
After they go through the whole shtick, they say that they were role-playing as the legendary Nugget Bridge trainers.
The legendary!
And they say all the same stuff word for word. And have the same Pokemon.
That's actually kind of fun. I don't know where any secrets are, so...
I'll let you know if I notice any spots that trigger.
Oh, I guess you're gonna have to take over, then.
Damn it! No! My Dr. Pepper lid.
You can have mine.
Bye!
Follow that boulder, Indy! Just...
Cove.
Just an alter universe where Indy is chasing after a boulder.
Oh, wait! Now the boulder is the artifact!
This is a giant rock that's made of gold.
No, 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 no!
Oh fuck, oh fuck, oh fuck, oh fuck.
Bad day, bad day, bad
day! Down!
No shit, Sherlock. Down! He might miss this one!
Jump! Count as a mini boss.
I guess.
Nope. us.
I like how it's only more of a threat than the normal enemy because it has a longer invincibility frame.
Also, it's got, like, hit points, it has which most enemies don't.
Well, it's attack-wise. Like, it has the same advantage that we have.
Yeah.
That has to be frustrating for enemies, having a temporary invulnerability.
Just... Oh, God, he's got iframes!
How do we kill this fucker? Ronimo, please nerf. Donkey and Diddy OP.
Donkey and Diddy. Alternate universe wherein,
Why didn't you grab it, monkey?
You hold up.
Nah, that's a bunch of shit.
Apparently not, because you died. Whoops. And I killed the DK barrel, too.
No, I didn't press up that time. I didn't press up that time, either. I think as long as you're holding a direction.
So you like, just kind of not held a direction, and then that's what happened?
Yeah, I must have had nothing on the D-pad.
Okay, makes sense, I guess. Combo.
No combo system in this game. You don't get extra... There's actually... I'm surprised there's no point system on a Super NES game.
Well...
Because that was still...
It would
still
be kind of distracting.
That. Like, I agree it would be pointless, but despite it being pointless, it was still an in thing at this time.
Yeah, it's what all kids are into, score. But...
Yay! Is that it?
No.
No. Well, we can save.
Yeah, we can save and then figure out what the fuck we did wrong.
It must have been hard work for you to come all this way.
39% already! Like, we might actually get this done this day. In one sitting.
Bear in mind, we have all the hardest levels yet to come.
Yeah, that might be a problem.
Oh,
there we go.
I thought, maybe I'll just try it.
Hey guys, what's going on?
Just hanging out. I'm gonna genocide you, okay? Okay.
Genocide. Oh, that would have come in handy. Is that all?
Speed run!
No. And then we have... Oh, is this... Speaking of...
Orangutan Gang. This one had some bullshit ones, if I remember.
Alright, well...
Actually, no, hold on. I want to do this. Fuck off, B.
So this is dawn of the second day. Yeah! Whee! Look at how cool I am!
Yeah!
You're missing all the secrets.
I don't think there are any before now.
I hope you're right. They don't have that in the second game, do they?
The barrel rolling? I don't know.
Or keg riding.
You can do that on wooden barrels, too.
You can?
Yeah.
Huh. I guess with the keg, it's better because it doesn't, like... No.
Okay, I know what I was thinking of this here.
Alright, what do you...
We're gonna need Espresso. He's later on in the level.
Alright. I'll go grab him. No, I'm onto your shit. What?!
Oh, what?!
What?! Wait a minute!
It's Hotline Miami! After the death of Donkey Kong, Diddy Kong must go on an epic revenge quest against the Kremlings.
Yeah, he's like, Diddy Kong wears the monkey mask.
Is that permanent? Is that gonna be that for the whole level?
I sure hope not.
Not that I'm gonna complain.
Good thing we saved. I've never seen that happen before.
Neither have I. I wonder if this is an emulator thing, or...
No! It can't be. Like, what?
Or this is just, like, how the Super NES reacts to whatever the fuck happened.
I rolled into a guy, and then somehow I died, and then the screen went all funny. That's some sunset.
Uh-oh.
I'm gonna say the factory did this.
Yeah. It's global warming. It's pollution in the air.
Pollution.
That's what the Alolan muck looks like, by the way.
Yeah, I saw the picture of that. It's fucking a rainbow and shit.
It's supposed to look like an oil spill.
Yeah, because that actually makes sense, because oil spills do look like that. You spill some oil and, like, it gets into water, it has, like, this really cool rainbow color.
There we go. Winky!
Winky!
I think I know what the prize for this is going to be, and I'm not going to like it.
Is it going to be a statue?
Is that what they are? No, I'm going to leave.
Gold statue.
I'm going to go over here. Can I leave?
You have no choice!
But I want to leave. I don't want it.
Yeah, you must take it. I insist. Solid gold.
God, Mom. Oh, there's more?
You can always just fuck it up. No.
We can do that, I guess.
Yeah, well, too late.
Oh no, I failed. Why?
Oh, by the way, we fixed the sky.
Oh yeah. Proper sunset now.
That was weird.
Oh no!
God damn it! Who just goes around burying gold statues everywhere? You know what? The Kremlings were right. There is gold here.
And we don't want it. Take it. There's no reason for conflict.
No, they stole our bananas too. Okay, that's unforgivable.
Right. Okay. Oh, you fucker.
Got the decay barrel. Use that. That it does work, right?
Barrel? No? Okay.
No? Okay. It does work. Good. Now let's get in.
Don't want. Oh, it's. Okay.
Oh, it's just a G.
Cog.
Cog. Gears of War! Just a bunch of space marines trying to fight a bunch of intelligent monkeys.
Now, this isn't quite secrets within secrets, but.
Oh, God. Oh, fuck you!
After
it's just the same fucking thing!
After falling in a pit that you would have had to guess that you could fall into, you have to fall in a pit in the pit that you have to guess that you can fall into.
Secrets.
How bored do you have to be to find out this shit on your own?
I guess pretty thorough. Four secrets in this level!
They weren't fucking around.
Rare seal of quality.
Oh, God, okay. I thought I was gonna die there.
Yeah, you finished the level, you've earned it.
Yay!
I would never have remembered that.
Oh, there's more!
What?!
How?
Wait! Five?!
How's there more?
There can't be more! You're yanking my chain! Wait, up there?
No.
No.
I know there's nothing up there.
Oh my God. There's more! God, you gotta be hardcore to like 100% this game.
This is one of the worst offenders, this level.
Yeah.
Like, you can tell that much.
I don't think we'll need to do research for this, though.
I've beaten this enough times that I'm pretty sure I got it.
Yeah. Meanwhile, when we start Illusion of Gaia, I gotta get a guide to make sure I remember all the secrets.
Yeah.
Because I don't.
Uh-oh.
Was it on top of the other, like, when you go down into then that fake pit, and you go, and you have that one on the far right, is that, like, on top? Is that alcove? Or...
Maybe. I think there might have been something between where we got Espresso, that first secret, and where it dropped us off. Maybe something around here.
Maybe. Alright, Espresso. Do we need him for this secret? Or?
Maybe. Oh, okay. Kill that thing, jump on Espresso, and go to the right, maybe.
Okay.
Maybe.
Maybe.
Be prepared to turn around if necessary, I guess.
Looks like a drop.
I mean, you can fly with Espresso.
Oh, yeah.
No. Oh,
no. Probably not. Hold on.
You cannot jump on enemies as Espresso.
I know.
Okay. And so Diddy remained forever unsaved.
Yeah. I was trying, man.
I know.
I'm not gonna figure this shit out.
You trusted me? Well, that was your fault.
Well, I mean, I was gonna get you alive and then follow your directions,
I know.
But I didn't realize there were five secrets, let alone.
Well, neither did I. Oh, maybe it. Maybe I needed one of those barrels.
All right, I'm gonna look it up.
All right, you do that. Not there.
Let me know when my turn comes up.
Alright.
Ring. Dash. Wu-Tang. Gang.
Plan.
There we go. Gang secrets. Oh! It's on the Super Mario Wiki.
Okay, what do you got?
This level contains the most bonus areas of any level, a total of 5. Hidden objects and collectibles, bonus levels. First one, halfway through level, find Espresso. Head west and travel backwards. That's the
we level. We got that one.
Yeah. Second one, have the Espresso with them. Go to N. Go to the area at the level N. Espresso with the cogs on him should jump off the cliff and flutter over to the abyss to the right until he lands on a safe platform. Three must fly over another abyss and land in an area with a barrel. You must dismount from the Oxus, break on a nearby wall, revealing an opening.
Okay, so where the N is at? Where you have to find that?
That's... And then...
So I'll get Espresso, and then I'll find the N.
Wow, this is a bottleneck. This level...
Shut up, phone! I'm speedrunning!
God, this level is awful!
Oh,
damn it.
Up to you, Kong.
Alright, let me know when the inn is found, and then just,
Well, you need Espresso first.
Yeah, so, there it is. There's the instructions.
There's the O, so the inn is gonna be coming up.
Yeah.
We got the checkpoint.
We can always go left from this, from here, so that's good. Wasn't N in like a bonus level?
Here's the N. So yeah. It was this spot that I was thinking of. We have to jump right off this cliff and flutter with Espresso.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Except you can't go far enough to see.
Damn it!
Yeah. All right. So we had to go under the thing and not go so fast that we got to the top.
Yeah, that's so weird.
I knew my feeling said it was there. I knew it was.
Yeah. You say that now. So I guess just don't hold Y and hit B when you get there?
Well, just watch that you don't go so far that you get on top of the thing. You might want to jump off and kill that guy, or not.
Nope. Damn it! You fucking assholes. Alright, I'm handing it off to you.
Alright.
Good luck. Wow, we spent a long time on this level.
Yeah.
5 secrets! Like, are you fucking kidding me?
Someone had a boner for this level. You know, we only have the fake Kongs in one level, so we gotta make full use of them. They gotta spend a lot of time on this one level.
Aren't they in a factory level too?
I don't know. They might be.
I thought they were.
Oh, okay. I actually didn't need that middle platform.
Yeah. You're that good.
What if you got here? What if you got to that entrance and didn't know that you could dismount animals?
Well, you'd be fucked.
That would be a very frustrated child, that.
Yeah.
Good.
Alright, when we get to the next one, just switch back to me, I guess.
Next one's underwater, the best level! Can I help you, monkey, save your game?
Yeah, sure. We're almost halfway done with this game.
Well, of course, that one level is worth fucking 10%.
10%?! Holy shit!
Not really, I was just making a joke.
Yeah.
Oh, right, yeah.
Thank you.
I was just sitting there for a few seconds wondering, oh, why is he not doing anything? Oh, right.
Yeah. So, the clams are here and they shoot pearls. Because that is what they do!
Yeah.
It would be great if you had a game and they use, like, pistol shrimp.
Is that, like, an animal?
Yeah, it's an actual animal that exists. They're, like, little shrimp, and they have the ability to generate heat. And they can use it to generate bubbles, and they fire bubbles at their prey to, like, stun them and paralyze them.
Okay.
It's really cool.
Oh, what was it? It was in, It was an entomology class.
Huh?
That, I saw a video about some bugs that were, like, little tiny, like, maggot-sized things that form colonies. And they seem, like, totally helpless against, like, big wasps and things that prey on them.
Yeah.
But if they're in a group, then they have a defense mechanism.
Oh, they do?
Yeah, they can, they actually surround the wasp, or whatever the bug was. I think it was a wasp or a beetle or something.
A predator.
They surround the predator, and they vibrate.
Oh, yeah, I heard about this!
They vibrate so quickly that they generate heat, and they have really high heat tolerance. The predator doesn't, and is roasted alive in its own carcass.
Yeah, I've heard it! That's hardcore!
And its exoskeleton. It's pretty brutal.
Nature, don't fuck around with nature. They got some really, like, the fucking Venus flytraps. Like, it's a plant that's carnivorous.
My god, so we should go bird watchings. I don't know why I made him German.
Swiss good, we should go bird watchings.
I don't know Swiss guys. It seems sounds kind of weird and dangerous.
Like, I hope they make, like, a Pokemon out of, like, pistol shrimp one day.
Yeah.
Or, like, or the fucking maggot,
the vibrating ants, the firebug type.
Yeah.
I don't know if they've had a firebug yet.
You should have. Fire ants are definitely, like, a thing.
But they're not actual. They're not actually related to fire.
Or, bullet ants! Yeah. You get stung by those things, you're gonna wish you were dead.
Because fireflies could be, like, they did firefly Pokemon, though, and they weren't fire type.
No. Poison type, maybe.
I still wish, when they announced that they were gonna have a new type, there were all these theories about what it was gonna be.
Yeah.
I was rooting for, like, light or sound.
But we got fairy.
Yeah, we got fairy. So I was a little disappointed.
Do you believe in miracles? There should be, like, a dark fairy type.
There's
like, based off of true fairy. Like, or true fae. You know, like, those asshole fairies that, like, kidnap people.
Gengar's the ghost Clefable, did you know that?
Oh, is ghost of Clefable?
Not literally. That's one of the fan theories I've mentioned before, is that they have the same size, shape, and outline. It's just Gengar is an evil version, and Clefable is the fairy version.
I like to see, like, Gengar and Clefairy just hang out, just, like, that'd be, like, a, like, best friend type deal.
Why did you get that?
Wasn't thinking.
Yeah.
Plus, fuck it, we got all the other ones, why not?
Sure, we need footage of it. It's content!
The fucking, the 4th Seat Studios motto, it's content.
I think this one has the, no, it doesn't have the fastest, the Rhino has the fastest timer.
Yeah. Because the Rhino goes really fast, I guess.
Incidentally, I think the Rhino's also the most fun.
To play as?
Personally.
Well, yeah, because he's just an unstoppable force.
Because it's at Rhino's normal platforming. It's just, yeah, running and jumping and smashing shit.
Yeah, you just don't stop him. And in the second game, he has the ability to, like, do the Sonic Dash.
Yeah.
Which is pretty cool.
Almost 5.
I'm happy with what I got.
Get out of the way, stalagmites!
Alright, how far back did that set us? Not far.
You know how you can tell the difference between stalagmites and stalactites?
One's on the ground, one's on the ceiling.
But which
ceiling.
Is which?
Might. Might is, roof, tight is ground.
Nope.
No? Other
when
way around?
The mites go up, the tights come down.
Is that a joke?
No, that's actually how you remember. Stalagmites grow on the floor, stalactites grow on the ceiling.
I guess it's in the sea now. So.
What?
This water at level.
Oh, yeah, or presumably in the ocean. Or it's, you know, like a bay, which is still salt water.
Yeah. Or a lagoon, which is apparently salt water.
Yeah.
Because, yeah, the water is nice and clear. So we don't get demons, we only get sharks.
Yeah.
I think we're good. I think there's no secrets here.
No, we're good.
Alright, let's get out of here. Yep, Clam City's done.
Clam City! That's my favorite city.
right.
But wait, the paths cross each other. Why couldn't we just jump in the water? I remember you struggling with this boss the last time.
Nah, I've learned.
Yeah. Patience, donkey son.
Patience. Patience and the ability to be ultra fucking chill.
Did you see the
also, after Lagoon, this is easy.
Did you see the Karate Kid Robot Chicken parody with NSYNC?
Oh yeah, I did. Enter was it NSYNC or was it Backstreet Boys? Damn it!
It was right, NSYNC. Enter the Fat One with Joey Fatone.
And then I pledge allegiance to the United States of Love.
Bye bye bye.
That's Backstreet Boys.
Bye 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 was?
Yeah.
Oh, that was NSYNC.
Was it?
Yeah.
I can't tell them apart.
One was 90s, one was 2000s.
What? Is that the difference? No.
No, I don't know. I think they were both 90s. One was early 90s, one was mid 90s, probably.
I legitimately... Oh, hey, this is the level where, that guy called Donkey Kong, like anybody who hates Donkey Kong, stupid.
We've come full circle. Okay, finish. I'm not gonna pick the one. I'm gonna know which one it is, and I'm not gonna pick it. I beat your game. Fuck your game.
Alright, so I remember this level not being too bad.
Yeah?
Also, is there ice physics?
There is. You were right.
Yep. I hate ice physics. I mean, I understand why it's necessary, but I don't like them all the same.
Yeah, Mario 1 had no ice physics.
Mario 1 didn't have ice physics. Mario 2, I also believe it didn't have ice. Oh, it did?
Remember there was that part where you were running on ice and there were the little marshmallow guys?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I remember those.
And there was another part where you had to run along ice and it was the Bezos flying at you. You had to duck and jump over and shit.
Oh, my God. Mario 2 was a fucking acid trip and a half.
Yeah. Worst ending for a Mario game. It was all a dream!
I mean, considering the nature of that game, that makes sense, but...
That's why Wart hasn't appeared again. He was just a figment of Mario's imagination.
Yeah.
If Mario created the Mario series, Wart would have been the bad guy.
And then Bowser would have been just a dream.
Yeah.
And people would wonder, why the fuck isn't Bowser a main villain?
Such a cool enemy. I don't need to go up there. No, we got the secret.
Fat frog.
Who hates vegetables? Good for Saturday morning cartoons.
you remember Rise of the Mushroom Kingdom?
Oh yeah, I showed you that.
No, yeah.
God damn it.
I actually watched that. I remember watching that myself like a while ago.
Yeah.
It was like, man, video game director's cut. Whatever happened to those guys?
Oh, I'm surprised you remember the name of them.
Yeah,
I don't know. They did. They had a few good bits. I still got to show you. Probably some of the better stuff I saw on Newgrounds was there was Beat Up Sandbag. I mean, you watched Super Mario Bros.
Same place.
You're big on that. And then Sonic's Quest for Power is on
Sonic's Quest for Power is my guilty pleasure.
Yeah.
Just because the animators really tried their hardest to make the fight scenes more and more DBZ.
Yeah.
And you know what? It actually looked pretty cool.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, the plot was pretty basic.
There was a tower defense flash game that was nothing special visually, but something that I actually spent a lot of time with. I'll have to stream of it one.
You do. You play a lot of tower defense games.
Do I?
Well, more than the average, more than me at least.
It's just that one, really. As opposed, like, what are some others that I play?
No, well, you're right. That's the only one you play. That's more than me. My none. I don't get the appeal of tower defense games, or rather, I get the appeal, but it's just not my kind of fun.
Yeah.
Like, you're talking about a person that prefers...
Oh god, I didn't want to pick it up again!
Good job. Are we gonna be stuck here in this level of all levels?
Freeze to death. Ah, I don't remember this level being too bad.
There's this movie called Frozen.
Yeah?
It's a different movie than you're thinking. It's not the one with the ice princess and her, like, sister. It was the one where it was, like, three assholes are stuck on a ski lift.
Yeah.
That's the movie. The guy, they go up there despite the place closing down, and then they get stranded up there.
And they can't just, like, slide down the wires?
No! Because they're razor sharp, I guess. In that universe of the movie. And then wolves come after them. Like, when the guy decides to jump off.
Oh, he jumps off.
Okay. He jumps off, breaks both his legs because he fucking jumped off. And then he's like, he gets devoured by wolves, and rather than fighting back, he just covers his face with his hat and goes, "Don't let her look! Don't let her look!" And then, I don't know where any of the secrets are.
There haven't been any. I don't think so yet.
Okay.
Good duck.
And then she tells a story about how I left a puppy all alone at home. I'm not gonna come home.
Suddenly blizzard.
I'm not gonna come home and she's gonna cock her head at the door. And then she's gonna starve to death. And then the other guy gave her a look where it's like, we really have to do this now.
Yeah.
It was funny seeing that movie. just from 2010, by the way, so.
Isn't that like the same year Frozen came out?
Yeah, I don't know, but the answer is probably yes. Also, something else is that the director of that movie insisted, because there are certain parts in that movie where it's supposed to be really cold.
I'll tell you now, you're better jumping on the birds than stopping and waiting, because it's going to make the platforming harder.
All right.
Oh, go straight down.
I wasn't straight down. Sorry about that.
That's okay. What were you gonna say?
The thing with the fucking thing with the director of that movie, I don't remember his name, but he's actually a really nice guy, but he has, like, he decided he was gonna try to, like, add legitimacy to his movie.
Yeah.
By saying, like, they're talking about his movie, like, oh, I know you said it was really cold, but you couldn't see breath in some of the shots. And then, like, a reasonable director would say, well, that's because we can't control the weather. Like,
yeah.
Sometimes it wasn't as cold. And then you'll be forgiven that. But he's like, no. It actually was really cold. It was so cold that their body temperature was matching their breath. And that's why you can't see them, because they were just really cold.
Oh, okay.
And a reviewer, Adam, from the channel Your Movie Sucks,
yeah.
He was like, he decided to investigate it two times. First time he contacted a YouTuber, he was like asking, is this true? And he's like, no, if that's going on, you're probably already dead. And then he called, like, an actual professor to talk about it, and he basically agreed. He had him on the phone, and he's like, he says, oh no, that's bullshit because of this reason.
Yeah.
And then as an aside, the scientist dude's like, so you basically trash other people's movies, is that it? And Adam was like, yeah.
Yeah? Was that the whole conversation? He didn't say anything after that?
No, he did. No, that was the whole conversation. He actually got that out of the way, and then he asked them about whether or not that was true.
This is a really precise level.
Yeah, no.
I don't know why you remembered it being easy.
I don't know. I always assume that, like, barrel blast levels are easy for some reason. I forgot that this one was, like, one of the more difficult ones. Oh, god damn it!
Hooray!
That better be all the fucking, secrets.
I think there might be one more.
Okay. Hope you remember it.
I'm treading very cautiously.
Oh, I don't think that's it. Thank you! Okay, good.
For a second, I looked at that, and I didn't see the exclamation point, because it blended in with the white. Slip, slide, ride, oh boy!
Talked a whole lot about fucking... Oh, this level's actually pretty chill. Talk about Frozen.
Let's its goals. I can't remember, did we tell that story on stream?
Oh, the one where it's like we were deciding to find
up covers.
Yeah, we were trying to find like cover stuff, like covers of songs, and there was like a metal cover of Let It Go.
Yeah.
And for the most part, it sounded like your traditional like death metal like screamy voice. Da 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 da. And then it got to the fucking
chorus.
Got to the chorus, and then this other dude, this like He had a really beautiful voice. He started singing it while the song. It was like a whiplash.
It was weird. And then you said that, oh wow, that guy sounds like Squiscar. The one guy sounded like Nathan, and this guy sounds like Squiscar.
Yeah, and then
and I'm like, are you thinking of the right character, Squiscar?
Yeah,
let it go. You were thinking of Toki, right?
Yeah, I don't know. I think I was. Which was the one that's not a bumblebee?
Toki.
Oh yeah, I was thinking of Toki.
Brown hair.
Yeah. 55 lives! We're basically not in danger of getting a game over anytime soon.
Nope. Man. How do these ropes work? Monkey magic.
Why are we sliding upwards?
Don't question it. Just roll with it.
Diddy, these they got elevator technology with ropes.
What was the main character's name in Roundabout? Redhead.
Yeah, I know who you're talking about. I'm trying to remember her name. It was Giorgio.
Yeah, Giorgio. Giorgio learned early in life to just go with the flow, not to fight it.
To go with the rotation. Giorgio never stopped rotating. Even when she drove straight,
she had to fight.
Oh! I like how the final challenge of that game was to drive straight.
Yeah.
Alright.
Oh,
I forgot. That's what I get for not playing that in a while.
I'll get a barrel and give it back to you. That was kind of a shit run.
Yeah. I'm not too concerned.
Oh!
good evade. Alright, where are the secrets?
I just got the one up there already.
Okay. Ah!
Good run. Number two. Oh no, I forgot. This game has danger.
I didn't forget! I know where I'm going now.
Because you saw the secret.
Yeah, I saw it.
I remembered that after jumping over to the bird, but it was too late. I was already dead. I just didn't know it yet. I wonder if the different levels have different,
I feel like I'm getting some lag.
Think so?
Or, at the very least...
I felt a very slight lag on when we played Mario World, but I don't feel it now, personally.
I think the thing is that I'm just not used to the hitboxes.
Yeah?
Alright, let's try it. Not this way. We're going this way. My reflexes are shit. Oh my God! I suck. Can you just let me have it again?
Okay.
I just want this. I want this for me. Okay. Yeah, fuck you. And sliding up.
Back. Oh.
Finish the fight!
Da da da. Don't care, don't care, don't care, don't. Oh no!
good evade.
Where am I?
Okay.
Here. I'm here. Okay.
Where am I?
No.
Good, dude. You're really good. You're really good with the jukes today.
Oh fuck! I needed that barrel.
Oh no, really?
Maybe not. Let's find out. Whee! Leap of faith.
So, do we need the barrel to kill an enemy, or do we need it to open a path?
No, I meant that those two bees were blocking the way. We could have killed one and gotten through there.
Oh, well.
But I just jumped and that worked out. I like this music track.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Pretty chill.
This level looks like a level out of Donkey Kong 2.
It does.
I don't know why, just the crystal graphics remind me of that game.
You're thinking of the mining levels and
yeah.
That started in the second world.
The mining levels had really good music in that game.
Oh no, those levels were really good with the music.
I once composed a song that I didn't realize was actually just that melody that I'd forgotten where it came from.
Oh really?
And I also heard someone else do that. So it's a really common melody. Like people really remember it. They remember the melody. They don't remember where it's from.
Yeah.
I say jolly. Wait.
Yeah. God damn it. This game. This game is full of like.
It's full of shit.
It's like all the levels.
Oh,
are...
Oh no!
Good one.
Okay, so I got hit, but it kept the momentum that Espresso had. I did not have any input in that. I was not hitting right.
Really?
Yeah.
That's so weird.
So it flung me off the mountainside at full force.
All right, where were you going?
Fuck if I know. Right. Go right. Colorado. Same thing, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I had no momentum. This is so weird. So nice I work a job that I'm able to do this, like, again.
Yeah.
For like, more than I'm used to.
As opposed to when you were working nights.
When I was working nights and I just had to sleep and be miserable. Now I can wake up, go to work, interact with people.
Damn it! Where was I supposed to go?
You gotta keep them alive, bro!
Okay, there is a secret up there, and I can no longer get up there. So, we'll come back for that.
Yeah. Anything else, we can just complete the level and then,
actually, we're probably gonna need Espresso for a secret, aren't we?
They wouldn't have given him to us if we did.
They might have. They might have just had it to make it, you know, an extra gameplay feature or make the level a little easier.
Yeah, it's like warps. Like, warps are useless if you do it 100%.
Uh-oh!
But they're handy if you just want to get through a level. Apparently warps are, like, necessary in speedrunning for the second game because it's actually faster to, like, to use the warp to complete a game. And then go back for the secrets and then start select out.
Were there warps in?
Oh yeah. You go into certain barrels and then.
You're talking about in one level.
No, there are multiple levels that had them.
But not like from world to world warps.
No.
Not like in Mario Brothers 1.
No, I'm talking about into level warps.
Well, that was embarrassing. So it looked like there was a spot up on the right that Espresso would be necessary for.
Well, we're gonna. Not get him this level. About to complete this level.
Oh, hey! They are. I remember you guys.
Oh, fuck!
Good save.
That rope didn't want to spawn, I swear to God. Alright.
It's the rope's fault. It wasn't feeling up to it.
Or is it the fact that I had the worst timing in the world?
It originates from the Powerpuff Z world, where all inanimate objects have feelings. Confirmed.
So...
I'm a piano that's sad because everyone who plays me is bad.
So then you get an episode where, like, one of the girls is trying to talk to her toy bear that was inanimate before it was possessed.
Octopus?
Yeah.
Octi.
What was it called in the original show?
Octi.
They kept it!
Yeah.
That's cool.
They kept pretty much all the characters' names. Unlike the new Death Note movie.
Shut up! You're still harping on that? I told you it would be set in America!
I know. I'm just bringing it up. It's content!
You get a white guy. Hi, I'm Light Yakami.
Then you get a black guy. Hi, I'm L.
Okay. I like the fact that they got a black guy to play him. They got a really good black guy, too.
It's not one of those bad black guys.
Or a bad actor.
Yeah.
Like, I would prefer there to be, like... Like a good actor rather than just having him there for race's sake.
I know.
Unless you desperately need a black actor for something and you gotta take what you can get. Like if the plot point is that he's black or something.
They make
Alright.
They make a live action Afro Samurai and it stars like a white guy. It
stars a white guy with a Jufro?
Yeah. It stars Nabashin. Or the guy
who played, a Japanese guy with an Afro!
The guy who played Napoleon Dynamite. As Afro Samurai.
Is he still acting? I don't know. Like, he did.
I don't even know that guy's name. Oh. Was Napoleon Dynamite an indie film?
I think.
I'm not sure.
It was made by Mormons.
Okay, that's important.
So I don't think it was independent. I think the Mormons got their, like, Mormon church friends to, like, donate a bunch of money.
Okay, so we gotta keep,
keep this guy alive. Or girl. No matter what.
We're gonna have to skip that secret and come back for that, because we need... You can't get all the secrets of... Almost proved me wrong. Well, you're gonna lose Espresso if you go for that now. Do you wanna... You can pick your secret.
There we go! Yoshi strats! Oh, didn't want to do that. Ah, damn it!
They thought of that! So actually, I guess we don't need espresso from the start. We can just get it there.
Yeah, but we need espresso to get up there.
No, we don't. You can bounce on the birds.
Oh, well. At the very least. What's this, what's the third secret?
It's the
never
one
mind, we, you can get it.
It's the one we need espresso for.
Yeah. I know, but what's that secret? Where is it? Is
oh,
it
fuck it. It's later on. It's just up on a ledge that we need espresso to get to.
Alright. Avoid the,
the Kremlin.
The checkpoint barrel.
Yeah.
If you can.
Come here, you fucker. I know you're there.
My grandma used to play this game, and she would always skip checkpoints.
Yeah? Just
just make it harder on herself.
Well?
You talk a lot of, well, we'd say a lot of nice things about Granny Xelrog, but Granny Anderson was hardcore.
Yeah?
Yeah. R.I.P.
You heard it here first.
Dude, she 100%ed Ocarina of Time.
Yeah.
Like, she would always, on her carts, she would always have, like, 100, like, a fucking,
complete file?
Save that was, like, 100% complete.
Wow, she and I get along, then.
Yeah. And yet, she got to the dwarf, desert and lagoon and just stopped.
Yeah.
So, she was a smarter person than I am.
Oh, God. Oh, okay.
Oh! Oh! Well, better whatever. Make this count.
That one couldn't have been avoided. I'm wary of you, you fucker.
It won't get you, because your legs are long.
I'm not
but those barrels will get you.
I'm not positive. I think there have been some occasions where I've been got by the claptraps, despite being on espresso. I know it's supposed to function that way where you can't get them.
Maybe on slopes?
Well, this guy would definitely get you, but I think even on flat ground it's happened to me once or twice.
There we go. Alright, we're done with this level.
Hopefully.
Oh! Blue balloons.
Blue the best?
I believe blue is the best.
Better get these, we're short on lives.
Yeah, blues are the best.
Da da da!
My balloons, because do monkeys love balloons?
I don't know.
Oh no.
I guess we just exit now?
Yeah, we just go.
Okay, good, we got them all. Croctopus chase? Another... Oh boy! You want it or should I?
I'll take it. Very strange, we're not freezing to death.
Interesting. It's all that monkey fat.
That fur. Man, these monkeys are hardcore. They're made of... They can also apparently breathe infinitely underwater.
Have you seen Donkey Kong 5?
Oh, is that a bootleg?
Yes.
Oh, I have not seen it.
No. I don't know if Joel ever played it. I know Vinny did briefly. It had some horribly translated story about... I don't know what the game it was modified from. It was like an evil wizard captured the monkey's human girlfriend.
Oh, God. Oh, okay, I know what you're talking about.
And corrupted the land.
Oh, shit. I fucked up.
So the sprite that started as Donkey Kong turned into Diddy because he starved and turned into a monkey. He got thinner and thinner.
So that, Diddy is Donkey's, like,
so Donkey
Mario
was,
form.
Yeah, exactly.
That's
Donkey
great.
Kong was the mushroom form.
Did it play like a Mario game, or did it play
I
like another
so.
Generic platformer?
It was basically a Mario game. It didn't have barrel lifting. It didn't have cartwheels. It was just jumping. Oh, there's still more stuff.
Oh, really?
I thought it would stop at the top for some reason. I don't know why.
Well, you stop at, like, just a left turn.
Probably because I saw the jellyfish in there. I was like, well, obviously, they don't want me to go this way.
Obviously.
That would be too hard.
Yeah, I thought octopi were, like, you know, not...
No, these are croctopuses. They're like, they're crocodile, octopus, horrible abomination half-breeds.
What the fuck? Alright.
Why are you- okay. Playing a dangerous game. They're trying to thread the needle between those fuckers.
Yeah.
I don't think there are any secrets on this level.
There better not be.
Monkeys actually better fit- better swimmers than sharks or octopi. Little did you know.
I beg to differ. I'm having to hit ham or B in order to get speed and shit, so...
But you're outpacing them.
Kinda. Don't go up, thank you. Alright, go!
Go, 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 go!
Gotta go fast.
S-O-N-I-C, go!
Go, 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 Gotta go fast.
So. Honestly, both versions are pretty equally silly sounding.
Oh,
so
wait. What the fuck? Oh no, no,
it
I
went
that
in
was
a circle.
Oh, did I?
It's still coming up, but there it is. So I think you missed an end guard.
Okay. Whatever.
So it's a little unnecessary that people that the English one is so meme-y. But that's because, you know, it was on that was on TV.
That was the one on TV saw. In Japan. We didn't get the Japanese sub.
That's what everyone saw.
It's like we either get comical. I prefer the Japanese soundtrack on the whole though.
Oh yeah.
But that's because I have a weakness to synthwave.
We're talking about Sonic X, by the way.
Yeah, Sonic X.
And it also had more traditional, like classical orchestral soundtracks.
Yeah, but I am a big fan of synthwave. Ah! Man, my epic run. Dead here.
Oh, I thought it missed us for a second there. Yeah, the synthwave was kind of Eggman's thing.
Yeah, darn. I guess there was a secret.
No, you fucker. The big shark looks less intimidating than the little shark. It doesn't look as mean, it looks friendly.
Yeah.
It's not, but it looks it.
Fish are friends, not food. Monkeys, though!
Ripper. What was it I asked you if you saw recently? An animated movie, like a Pixar or something?
Pixar. Oh, Madagascar.
Oh, yeah. Which you hadn't seen.
I hadn't seen it.
It was average.
It was like, what? Like, some people are trying to escape the zoo to go to Madagascar.
And one person unwillingly.
And you got some penguins who are like,
secret agents.
Oh, were they?
They act like it.
But do they act like secret agents or mobsters?
Secret agents.
Okay.
That's their shtick. Because tuxedos.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they're wearing suits. Oh no! This gimmick!
You want it or should I?
I'll take it, fine.
Take what you can get. Every time we get to a garbage level, that's Jack's only chance to take over.
Garbage level. Because you don't want to do them. Ah! Seizure procedure!
I offer to, I don't mind.
Well, I want to play too.
I know.
Like,
we just.
This is a perfect game for two player stuff.
Every time we get back to,
Oil.
Every time we get back to you having an opportunity to play, it's always a crappy level, though.
Well, that just means it's a challenge. Ah! Just short! Damn it.
Yeah! Rain!
I am severely out of practice in this game.
Yeah. What was the story? I think we started playing... This was the first Super NES game we played, and
there
we played Versus.
Here.
Yeah, I'm looking that way. And we played Versus.
Yeah.
And then after this, we did,
We did Donkey Kong 2. If we're being exact, we did Donkey Kong 2, and we did Versus in that, up until the point where the file deleted itself.
Is that what happened?
That's what happened. Okay. And because of that...
Well, no, we also played Mario World around that time, and you said, you know what Mario World taught me? Cooperation is fun.
Yeah.
Oh, you fucker.
Jack gets it back!
Sans, you asshole.
Sans got a lot of meat on his bones.
This is Sans when he was alive. He was one of those guys.
He was he's secretly a Kremlin.
Andy a second now. He's
what are they supposed to be? Like generators?
Oh, they're just spinning tires. Like we had the friendly tires we bounce on, these are evil tires. These are Kremlin tires. These are from the opposing car sales lot down the street. They're bad tires.
They're tires that that one fucker, the psychic tire had.
Oh yeah, these are the psychic. Oh, set it down. Okay, there we go. And there's a G in here for some ungodly reason.
Also a tire. Boom.
Not even gonna go for the G?
Oh well. Sure.
You're not gonna be able to make it from the tire, you need to bounce on the guy.
Oh, do I? There we go.
Cog.
Cog! Locusts must die! Alright. Is that enough? No!
A lot of HP.
Die, you motherfucker!
Only when your belly is empty of gold, then you have my permission to die.
Then you
They did Bane versus Venom, but I know fuck all about Bane on that death battle.
Oh, they did?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
The most recent one.
I
know he was the one who, like, broke Batman's back, but that's all I know.
Yeah, he did that in the comics, too. Like, originally he was, like, this, like, another mindless henchman, but then he developed a personality and became, like, this sadistic taskmaster.
Oh, so Kefka.
Yeah.
He's one of those characters.
No, they based that portrayal,
That's Funky.
Yeah, we don't need to do this.
Whoa, dudes, my name's Funky Kong.
They developed air barrel technology. Alright, I took care of that, you take care of this.
Okay. While you're going on your Bane story.
So
whose sidekick, or what, whose minion was he?
Poison. Well, in the movie, in the terrible Batman and Robin movie, it was Poison Ivy's villain.
Oh, I didn't know he was in that.
But traditionally, he's just like a guy that he kind of does crimes and people hire him to do like crimes.
Oh, he's like a mercenary.
Yeah, and he kind of sort of is in the Dark Knight trilogy.
Like, in the comics. In the DC comics, Deathstroke never really had his own endgame either. He was just for hire, right?
Yeah, those are some of the best ones. They're just ones that are, oh, we're doing this for the money. Because you can always trust them to do what's best for them.
Yeah.
You got guys like the Joker, you don't know what the fuck they're gonna do.
Yeah.
Alright, I don't know what the secrets are.
My secret sense is not triggered yet.
Isn't this one where it's like you gotta make a leap of faith?
I don't know.
No, this looks like a level where you gotta do some bullshit.
I'll see if I recognize a spot like that.
Oops.
That was not one of those spots.
I was just trying to get the O.
I know.
No, I remember because this has the same palette as that level.
As what level?
As, like, I think this is the level where it's like you gotta make a blind leap of faith. Yeah! I'm pretty sure it's down there!
I'm not.
Okay.
If we're missing a secret and I have to come back and jump down that hole, you're more than welcome to rub it in my face.
You have my permission to die.
You have my permission to gloat.
Look for Guy to just say that. We're almost to the end of the level, we didn't hit one secret.
Nope.
I think we're gonna have to get, we're gonna have to
I know, there's one coming up, I know that.
Up there! There we go.
Nope, don't want. What if I was rushing through and I got it by mistake? That would suck.
We don't want your stinking gold.
Bye! You might be right, because I remember, like, always missing one secret on this level.
Yeah. Yeah, I know I'm right. You're gonna have to make a blind leap of faith.
Really naughty.
Yeah. Not yet. We gotta get the guy.
I got a guy. His name's Deathstroke.
It'll take out your target.
Valmont hires Deathstroke.
AKA Slade.
Yeah.
I just want to get that out of there. The people who did Teen Titans found Deathstroke too hardcore a name. They changed it to Slade, which actually is a cool sounding name.
To be fair, they're basically two totally different characters.
I guess. Because Deathstroke is just like a mercenary for hire, and Slade...
Deathstroke is a lot...
What did Slade want?
Deathstroke is a lot more up and in-your-face physical in his approach to things.
I guess.
Whereas Slade is more calculating, and he's got these robots and these evil schemes.
Evil
schemes. He's a machinator.
He's like serious Eggman.
Yeah.
Also, he's got Doombots. He's got, like, robotic clones of himself.
Yeah, the only...
Like, I'm pretty sure it's this one.
Go for it.
Actually,
you said last time it was... There are three. There's the O, there's the banana, and there's the G. My gut says G, but that's still just a guess.
We're guessing at this point.
Do you want to just try all of them? I don't know.
Yeah, sure.
Nope, wasn't that one.
Not that one.
Thanks, Rare!
We got the lives to spare. I don't know. That's why, like, they have so many lives. They'll expect people to just...
Jump down random holes and hope for the best.
Yes!
Nope, not that one.
Okay, it's the G then.
Maybe. Or it's something that just neither of us are thinking of.
Probably that one.
Like, the most of a plan...
Somebody's gonna be watching this later. You idiots!
the most of a plan Slade ever had was trying to get Robin as his apprentice.
Yeah.
Like, his most ambition was Willy Wonka. I need an heir.
Well, I mean, Robin is pretty cool in that show. Not so much in Go, where he's kind of a lame-o.
Yeah. Oh no, the guy who's serious about being a superhero. Fuck that guy. You guys are all too busy having fun with your superpowers.
Alright.
Getting in wacky sitcom shit.
Right, let's see.
Nope.
So none of them. What are we missing then? Alright. What's the name of this level?
You immediately go to your phone. Rope Rampage? I don't remember.
That's why there's two of us.
So we can look shit up?
Yeah. Plus, I'm curious as to, like, where he could be. So not down there. Wait, is it down? Is that the one?
No, we did that.
Oh, yeah.
We tried it. That was the G hole.
Okay.
The G spot.
G spot.
We did that.
Not up there.
Is it between where that one enters and lets out? Maybe it's in here. No, could you imagine there's a hole in that? Where the fuck would that go?
Just falling. Oh, God. Well. So.
Nothing? You're not finding anything?
I'm fine. I'm here. I'm just,
In the meantime.
Second pit.
Second pit?
Second pit, from the beginning.
Okay.
So basically what we need to do is finish the level and then go back to the beginning.
I thought I just did finish the level, didn't I? No, I jumped off.
No, you jumped off. What? Car alarm! Damn it! Car alarm distracted me.
Yeah.
Burp! 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 What are you doing?
Trying something.
Will that reset it?
Let's find out.
Alright. It probably won't. Fuck, it just complete the level.
It reset the Kong letters.
It did.
Speed run! Failed.
Alright, I'm taking over. We're taking over.
The monkey rap was a strange direction for the series.
DK Donkey Kong?
That was very much a 90s thing.
Yeah, his coconut gun can fire in spurts.
I don't know why people remember that fondly, because I didn't grow up with it.
They don't remember it fondly, they just remember it. It was...
But everyone is constantly quoting the DK rap.
Everybody's constantly quoting Shrek! That doesn't make that popular!
Quoting what?
Shrek!
Oh, that's a good movie.
A lot of people don't... What about everybody quoting B-movie?
Yeah. It was okay.
Or what about, everybody talking about All-Star?
Well, I've only heard people reference Donkey Kong 64 fondly.
I've heard the opposite. Like, people are like, it's too much shit to collect in Donkey Kong!
Oh, I've heard that too, but people still remember it fondly. They're nostalgic about it.
I played it, it's not a bad game. I just remember being overwhelmed at the amount of shit I had to go collect.
Yeah.
So, alright, second pit.
Oh, I thought it was... You're right.
Just give it to me. I'll take care of it. Alright, pit one.
Straight down. Right there.
God!
I'm surprised I didn't get that one.
To be fair, I knew... I remembered that it was in a pit. I just didn't remember which one.
Wink it!
Yeah, you're useless.
Just ignored.
Was like
Winky starved to death later that evening.
Really naughty rampage.
And now you're gonna get all but the last hit in, die, and then I'll get it. Or you'll get one hit in, die. That
I forgot. Happen. I forgot he the timing. I forgot about the pattern he has. That he just jumps high and then jumps to the side.
Yeah.
Chill out, Beavis. I'm trying to score. That's it.
Bananas.
Alright. Holy shit, we might actually be done with this soon.
We still got the two hardest worlds to get through, remember. Oh. Although this one, I'm confident.
Well, what's the last one after this?
Is the mines.
Oh, okay.
Which I said was my least favorite.
Yeah. This is my least favorite. Secret one. Which one is the one with the secret in the secret?
I don't recall. We're gonna find out. I'll recognize it when I see it, hopefully.
Okay. You need to summon a barrel in that one.
Yeah.
You summon it by, like, I think you have to get all, like, it's a matching game, you gotta get all one.
That's not a secret. I thought there was a Rambi down there somewhere else.
So a Rambi?
Yeah.
Alright.
Harambe.
Don't bring that up.
If we had a chat, it would be, like, exploding.
Dicks out.
You know what? I'm happy we didn't make any Harambe references until this point in the stream, though, in Donkey Kong.
Yeah.
I'm proud of myself. Harambe. Okay, hit that. Yeah. And then the left wall.
There we go.
If you missed that jump, there would have been no way back.
Oh, is this the one?
Maybe. I think so. I think you want to get the banana.
Just the one banana, yeah.
Yeah. Can you get it, or do you want to swap?
I can... Yeah, you do it. Yeah!
You fuckers. Oh, wait. You also have to tech it. I forgot.
Oh, really?
That wasn't enough. We're gonna have to come back.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
You
have to jump while you're doing the barrel so that you walk into the thing before you hit the ground and do the celebration anime.
Fuck you, Rare! Like, you designed a really good game, but that's just bullshit.
It's a bonus level that's designed around a glitch. Is this the ramp?
Hey guys, I found a glitch we could do!
Let's make it part of the game!
Sure, why not? What the fuck?
It's a feature!
What the fuck is...
I don't know. Jump in the hole, donkey!
Alright, do I need to jump down there, or...?
I think it's Rambi down there, maybe. Possibly.
Rambi would help.
Or you just get the tire. You got the tire.
Yeah.
Tires is good. I said you saw Roland. Or what was that movie name? The tire one?
I know. Fuck, what was that tires movie's name?
Tired.
Tired. Tired. No, it's
oh,
not
no,
called-
we're gonna get tired, man! Game over!
Fuck. It was like...
It's about a psychic tire.
Yeah, I gotta see that movie. It's got a low IMDb rating, but it's because it's too high concept for some people.
Oh. God damn it, just off screen for a split second.
Yeah.
I think that was the most we could get from the tire anyway.
Makes sense.
We didn't need anything else for it.
Secrets in secrets. Oh, here!
There it is. Get over here. Get. Another good music track. Oh, come on!
Good one, Dad.
The momentum thing happens.
I'm gonna charge directly head on to the enemy's attack.
You don't need the tire, do you? Or what was that? I don't remember that one. Rambi's in the hole on the
left. It was a DK barrel. Mm.
Donkey Kong Country, the game that rewards you for jumping blindly into holes.
Fuck!
I'm glad they didn't do any of that shit in Donkey Kong 2.
They actually made it, like, obvious. Damn it.
Or at least, you know, readable.
Although they did do a dick thing with the secret in that game.
I didn't even need it. With, which one are you talking
about? The item hidden in one of the worlds. Like, the second level of the second world.
I don't remember which one you're talking about.
It was the first crystal level with a really cool music, and then you have to go inside a bonus level, and while you're there, you have to collect a certain item.
Yeah, I don't remember.
Because that's where it was hidden. Well, when we get to it, I'll show you. I remember that one sticking out to me the most.
Yeah.
Just like, wow, fuck you, game.
Oh, he's got a...
He's double tapping.
He's got a double barrel.
We're almost done with this.
Get it!
Yeah. Double barrel buckshot.
Well, you survived for a second there.
I should have memorized the pattern.
Yeah, they trick you there.
We got about an hour left. We can do this.
Yeah. Okay, so we need Rambi. Do we need Rambi again? What was the one we missed? Oh no, we're
oh, that was the love the bonus within a bonus.
No, yeah, that was
that you got a tech. I didn't realize you had to do it that certain way.
Neither did I. That was the start of the level, so we're gonna have to come back in.
And the funny part is, I remember you previously going, "No, I have to do it a certain way," and and then I'm like, "Why?" And then you never answered, and now I know why.
Get it. Come on! Rambi, you suck. Nope!
At least whatever,
he sucks.
Precision platforming with a rhinoceros.
Not the easiest thing in the world. Gorillas are much more suited to it.
Yeah, because they swing out in, like, vines and, like, jump and stuff.
Yeah. The Tarzan platformer that never was.
Oh, there was a Tarzan game. Totally.
On, what was that?
I think
PlayStation
it was
4
or PlayStation or something.
I think it was PlayStation. It might have been cross-platform. A Bug's Life was on N64.
Yeah.
That was widely regarded as a pretty bad game.
I saw it played. Yeah, it looks terrible.
I actually had it on the N64.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
How'd that work out for you?
Never beat it.
I figured.
Never got very far because it had a really weird save system.
Oh, really?
That I think you did have finite lives for a game that was pretty long and story-heavy.
Oh, there was permadeath in that game!
You could get a game over. It was, imagine being able to get a game over and having to start your file over in a game as lengthy as Zelda. Why? I didn't need to do that. Did I? No, this isn't the one.
This isn't the one. Just get a second life.
There yeah, it was the one.
So this one you have to go all the way to one. Yeah, here's where you need the barrel.
Yep. Gotta do the thing again.
What? Take it!
Yep.
There you go.
Those fuckers. Donkey!
Donkey.
Donkey. Do you think somewhere there's a mob boss whose last name is Key?
Key? One half of- Oh wait! Kong!
Oh, this is gonna be the full thing. This what- They made this the most rewarding secret in the game for obvious fucking reasons.
Yeah. All the lives.
Country? Oh right, there's an O in country.
I think they made like an entire, alphabet out of these.
I'm sure. It's available as a font somewhere on the internet.
What is this? It's country font. I think that's it. Let's get out of here.
You can download the Pokemon game fonts.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
Trick, track, track.
Is that the one with the moving platforms?
No. This is just another one of these levels.
Yeah, no. It's the one with the moving platforms.
Okay, it's one of them. It's not one of the bad ones.
Yeah.
This one, you're just riding the platform. It doesn't run out of fuel or any shit like
that. Oh, wait. That's not till the second game, I think.
No, that's in the mines level.
Oh, really? Oh.
The mines world.
No wonder you hate that world.
It has a lot of frustrating gimmicks.
Well, it's the final level.
Final world, yeah.
The final world, yeah. Levels are this, worlds are that. What are the secrets in this one?
There might be a couple. That's going to be a pain to get back to because, you know, it involves waiting.
Waiting. Yeah. The best part of any game.
Man, I love running around in circles while my Pokemon egg is being laid.
If you hate, like, waiting, you would hate playing Braid, because one of the secrets in that game requires you waiting, like, an absurdly long time.
Yeah. That's the best way to unlock Mewtwo, though. And,
although from what I gather, Braid actually looks pretty fun to play, so.
God damn it.
Had to roll.
I'm gonna try it.
Try it.
I think I can tech it.
You can do it!
Oh,
you did it!
Yeah! Woohoo! Also, MapleStory. They have the fucking gall to,
Oh, really? Oh, yeah, back to MapleStory.
To make it so that, if you're traveling between areas of the game, between, like, continents, you have to wait for real-time intervals for the ship to arrive.
I heard it. I remember that. That's
the brief
bullshit.
Moments we played.
Oh, man.
To wait for 15 minutes on the hour. You know, my favorite part of travel. Waiting for the bus stop.
There's a reason why we call it fast travel, people, because we don't need to wait.
They did introduce a fast travel feature that you can, like, pay for.
But you can still... Oh, you have to pay for it!
In-game money, I think.
You see...
I missed another one. Come here, you fought. No! Okay, that's okay. We got a checkpoint.
Yeah. I'll try it.
So, when it starts going down and there's a beaver, you gotta jump on the beaver.
That one? No. Up!
Another great start from Jack.
Hit Y, and then he just rolled forward, and I failed to autocorrect here. Can I get it?
No.
Can I try again?
No, I can't. You can't change Kongs on these platforms.
Really?
Yep.
Fuck me!
You have to be in a non-moving one.
Yeah, that's the one. God.
Da da da. Oh, this fucker jumps.
Yeah, he jumped with you?
Yeah, not very high, though.
He can also backstab him, it seems like.
Backstab?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah, attack him from behind.
Back.
Sorry, Dark Souls up.
Not fast. I waited too long. He got too fast.
Oh, that's the checkpoint again.
Yeah, so we get sent back.
Why do we get sent back?
We get rewarded with bananas, but punished in progress.
Well, whatever. Secret setback, whatever. WE muted. Alright. Oh no! We got him! Imagine these monkeys fighting off Britannians.
Yeah.
Like they tried to get
well,
an
that guy was
and,
a
like,
jape.
What?
That guy was a jape. He wasn't even chasing us.
He was scared.
Like monkeys in nightmares?
No, just monkeys fighting off like Britannians. Like, oh, they're trying to mine the saccharidite from our island. We better stop them.
I can't use my Gios. It only works on humans.
These monkeys are kicking our asses. We gotta do something, Emperor.
Emperor tries to use memory wipe, and the monkey's just still standing
there. They laugh at him!
Standing there picking his nose. Fuck.
Alright.
You got it, donkey.
I got it. Is there another secret? Got
I don't
it?
Know.
Probably not. No, this is it. Oh, you son of a fuck!
Under him is maybe a secret.
Under?
Yeah, roll into him to kill him. I guess you can't
roll into him!
I guess you can't touch
roll into him!
Well, I said him, not his barrel. Granted, I didn't know.
How was I supposed to know his barrel was one big hitbox?
How was I?
But why are you blaming me for that shit?
You're
then?
Not. You sounded mad at me. Let's just all love each other.
Just like you tell him roll into him as if you think it'd be fine.
Well, he was facing the other direction when I said that.
Well, whatever. Okay.
Whatever, ignored.
Fucker! I'm not mad at you anymore, don't worry about it.
Oh god. I am gonna have to deal with that one buff dude dropping on me again, though.
Him.
Not him, he's a jape.
He's a jape?
Yeah.
What the fuck is a jape supposed to be?
A trick.
Oh. Oh, like, oh, yeah. Jape. Jungle jokes.
Jungle japes.
Is that Rare trying to tell you this level is a joke?
I mean, that's not what this level's called, but...
No, I mean, back in Jungle Japes, it's like, oh, this level is a joke, you'll be fine.
Yeah.
Jape. We'll have a jape. Oh, you have
going
it a laugh?
For a ride? You're having a laugh!
There you go.
Okay, here we go. There!
Yeah. That would have sucked if you had three of those.
Yeah, I didn't even want that.
Blues.
Whatever. Don't care.
Oh yeah, 59 lives. Carry us through. And that should be the end of that level.
Then we get to the mines and lose all of them.
You really don't like the mines.
I'm kidding. I think the second cart level is in this world, though.
Elevator antics!
I remember this level. When I was a bab, when I was young, this level is where I dead-end stopped my progress in the game.
Why?
Because I did not understand the roll jump mechanic, which is mandatory for this level.
Oh, yeah. You didn't understand that you could still jump when you were rolling?
Right.
That makes sense. I mean,
I was treating it still like a Mario platformer. Here, you want this one? You haven't played.
I'll try it. Just let me know where everything is. Alright, and...
There's a letter K up there.
Yeah, I got it.
Don't touch the front of the Goomba!
I'm trying not to!
I know. That was like one of those Goomba deaths, though, where you touch just the very side pixel of the top. And it's a bullshit death.
Yeah. Here, give it back to me. Thank you.
Is there something down there?
I'm so displeased right now.
Yeah?
I'm not amused.
Oh no, 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 no. Fuck snakes. I hate snakes! I hate them!
Show a little backbone, Indy.
Why, thank you, Dickby, that I could not see.
I
love getting violated by large stingers.
Back to the beginning. We got that,
Yeah, we're good.
That one up there, so. I hate my reflexes. I hate the fact that my reflexes are just so fucking slow.
That wasn't a matter of reflexes. That was a matter of you were in the air and couldn't react.
You don't need a cover for me.
No, no, that was serious.
Okay.
Because you don't have as much control in the air as on the ground.
You have more control than, like, Simon Belmont, I guess.
As little as that says.
Yeah, Simon... I just realized, Castlevania has, like, the worst air control I've ever seen.
You mean none?
None!
There are some games that have none.
Fuck!
That was the one that almost got me. Oh, I remember... I think I remember a dick one around here.
Oh, no, what's the one? No, no, no,
no. No 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 no. Thank you, Shia LaBeouf.
What?
I guess he said that in one of the Transformers movies. He was like, no 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 no
no no no no no no no no.
Yeah.
Well, that's what I say all the time. Don't compare me to fucking Shia LaBeouf.
Oh, okay. Is that bad?
Do it! Don't let your dreams be dreams.
Good message.
I guess so. Unless he's telling you to kill yourself.
Is that your dream?
No. I'm just saying that Shia LaBeouf would- God! Fuck these-
Fucking Goombas!
Like, this is such bullshit!
Suddenly snakes.
Like, it's not even the fact that it's suddenly snakes, it's the fact that I dropped to a supposedly safe place and then, oh, look, a snake's crawling up your ass!
Well, why would you assume it was safe?
You gotta take your time!
You gotta go slow and observe! It's like spelunking, man!
Shut up!
I'm not making fun of you, I'm making fun of the game design.
What are you talking about? Game design's perfect!
Oh, okay. And if you think otherwise, you are stupid.
I know it's insulting, but it's the truth.
Such sad music.
Yeah.
It's like the game knows how hard this level is.
I mean, you're having trouble with it too, so.
Nope, fuck you.
I just don't. Fucking snakes!
Nothing down there.
God!
No, 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 no.
There we go, we got him. You got him, rather. So, where the fuck is everything?
I wonder if there was a secret down there.
Maybe.
I mean, if I'd brought the barrel to that wall, maybe.
Can you get out of a barrel from
I don't,
across
well, I,
there and then come
now
back?
I'm wondering if there's something down here. I can't imagine. They wouldn't do that.
We're gonna have to come back to this level anyway.
I'm sure we will. You fucker.
Okay. Wait a minute. Go back. Drop and hold right. Because I think there's a secret down there.
I don't think there is, but...
I saw an alcove. No? Okay. Well. I thought there was. Okay, so you said... No! Fuck you!
Try to hold on to that.
I know.
You can.
Take it across?
Yeah.
Okay.
Wait for him. He'll just kill himself. Oh, there's another one.
Well, you,
well, you have extra ammo. You can kill the bee and then have one.
There we go. And then it's further, further forward?
Yeah.
Alright.
And you're gonna have to jump over the guy on top. Guys.
Damn it!
We don't know if there's a secret there or not.
We'll find out.
If only you could throw your partner.
And we mentioned this before about that being a good game design choice, but alas, it was not meant to be today. They thought about it too late.
At least for Donkey Kong Country. Little Big Planet, arguable.
Alright. And...
there's something down there.
Fuck, I can't believe I survived that. It says something down there?
Maybe, I don't know.
I'm not risking it.
Okay. We'll wait until we know we missed a secret.
Let's wait till we have access.
Have we gotten any secrets yet?
The one at the very beginning.
This spot right here.
Yeah, you're right. It's impossible without jump rolling. Or roll jumping.
Or it's at least very, very difficult.
Good luck to you, sir. Hopefully you'll have better luck with the kegger than I will.
Kegger?
It's not an intergalactic kegger Oh, yeah, you have another one. Never mind.
Jaeger.
It's not an intergalactic...
Oh, there's another guy.
Yeah. It's not an intergalactic kegger down here.
Nope.
Nope. All right. Well.
Well, fuck you.
You sure showed him.
At least now I can check down here. Nope. Just hot death. Oh, I could have survived. You're up, donkey.
Damn it. Why are you sucking today? Alright. Why am I sucking today, for that matter?
It's okay. Together, we suck together.
Yeah. It's fun to suck together.
Not each other. Together. No.
Get sucked together. There's like a theory a person had... Where it's like, who would win in like a contest to convincing a person not to kill themselves versus a person to kill themselves? Shia LaBeouf or John Cena?
Huh?
There's a guy who's on top of a roof and he's on the fence about whether or not to kill himself or not. And John Cena's trying to convince the guy not to, and Shia LaBeouf is trying to convince the person to go for it.
Wouldn't it be the other way around?
Why would John Cena want to convince anybody to kill themselves?
Why would Shia LaBeouf? Just do it! Is that why?
Yeah. Do it! Some guy actually said...
Poor Shia.
I actually don't hate him. I just hate the fact that he's been typecast as this as like nice guy loser. Yeah. Dogged dude. I saw him in Holes and I'm like, oh, that they're gonna typecast him as that from now on, huh?
The most I know him from is Even Stevens.
So you could imagine my shock when I found out. Wait, he's in Nymphomania.
Is he?
He is. He's like a major character in Nymphomania.
Ah, the there Mario World.
You were looking for that one. You knew it was coming.
Nothing.
All right, that's it.
Please.
Oh, no, it's not. God. All right.
Looking it up.
Failed the spot check. 77%. We're almost through.
So we got this one up there.
It can either be... It is either a wall one or... Like, hidden... is like leap of faith based. Hold on. Oh, there's a map. We can... Okay, Donkey Kong Country Atlas. Show me the money. Oh, dude, it's a GIF!
Yeah?
Alright.
I'm sorry, but I don't find Candy Kong attractive. How dare you, Sandy?
Oh, is that...
She's a beautiful, beautiful woman.
Is that Mr. Dragons?
Yeah.
Hey, Sandy Dragons. You gotta come over again one of these days.
We do not tolerate body shaming on this stream. What, just because she's got a little body hair?
Alright.
I think it's around here.
Wait. I think at the very end with, like, the elevator, I have to go to the very top and then jump right. Maybe.
Very end? What? What elevator?
The very end elevator. The one where...
The one that went down?
Yeah. But I'm double-checking, so double elevator antics. I'm gonna confirm this. Very beginning of the level. So, crawling under three walls near the beginning of the level, the heroes enter an open area with few ropes, all guarded by zingers. Climb to the top of the last rope, hop to the right.
So I was right, it was there.
Yeah. You were. Sorry for doubting you.
Oh god!
Over here, yeah.
Oh, you fuckers. Okay. Up to you.
I think it's this one, at least.
You have to go to the right and then jump right, yeah. Yeah, yeah, boy. Oh, you fuckers.
Rare doesn't fuck around!
So, I am Diddy. Jack is Donkey. Donkey! And we are 100%ing this
game. Well, that's good. We didn't...
Now you can escape.
Yeah, we're escaping.
Okay.
I'll save again. So, yeah, we're gonna try to get this done tonight.
We're trying for a one-sitting stream, and I think we're gonna do it. We can go a little over our 7 o'clock limit if we need to.
Yeah. Oh!
So now we're in a poison pond.
The monkey... Kongs are so tough they can swim in fucking sewage!
Go left.
Left from here?
Just keep going down the wall.
Okay. Du-du-du-du-du. Is the wall weak here? Yay! Thank God.
You know, it's one of those illusory walls. You can only see through it if you get the lens of truth, but that's a late game item, so let's just go through it now.
Some guy actually managed to get to the fucking Shadow Temple as Young Link.
There are ways to speedrun. You can't do anything there as him, but...
No, you can! You can grab, like, the fucking hover boots early. Oh.
Okay.
And that's apparently important. Also, you can glitch through the Door of Time.
Yeah.
And, like, get Adult Link early.
You know that guy who does all of the glitch videos for Paper Mario?
Yeah, the one dude who's really committed to it.
Yeah.
More power to him.
Spearheading the glitch Paper Mario community. He released a video of the 10 easiest glitches in Paper Mario.
Oh,
and there are some surprising ones. It looks really easy.
We gotta do a stream where you just show off all the glitches we could do.
Yeah.
Just breaking Paper Mario. More so than we've already broken it, but...
We did break it pretty badly just by using shitty emulation.
Well, emulation in general. Alright, let's go.
I imagine emulation gets worse for later N64 games.
I don't know, Conker seemed pretty alright.
Was Conker late?
Yeah, it was
issues.
It was after Banjo-Kazooie. It actually ran better than Banjo-Kazooie.
Yeah, that's true.
It was weird.
I can't imagine.
And heartbreaking.
I can't imagine how Banjo-Tooie would run. Maybe it'd be better.
Maybe better.
It'd be optimized.
Yeah.
Although Banjo-Tooie is a bigger collectathon than one, right?
Yes, but it also has limited multiplayer, so it kind of evens out.
First-person shooter Banjo.
Oh, it does have that. It's like an actual... Like, a couple times you have that. It actually doesn't play too badly. It's like, it plays kind of like GoldenEye.
Yeah. By the way, they have a Let's Play on the Dr. Pepper bottle.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Who are they advertising?
It's like a movement to get, like, kids outside playing.
Oh! Oh, well, that's not a Let's Play, then!
No, I think someone didn't get the memo to them that it was, are you going everywhere? Are you checking for secrets?
I am. I haven't been finding any yet. Wait. Ah, damn it.
There's just Endgard in here. Go. It's faster to go up that way now.
Yeah.
Hey, one for Diddy. That'd be logical, right? No, can't ride it.
Two Endgards for every boy. ever heard of that song?
No.
Two girls for every... And that's how the song began. I don't know how it goes, but...
Is it a rap song?
No. It was like a... It was like 50s, like, rock song.
Yeah.
It's like you got jazz musicians and their band songs called Love for Sale.
So it's a Mormon's dream, right? a polygamist's dream.
Yeah. The problem with polygamy is that you don't get much,
All Mormons are not polygamists, I will say that now. And I'm pretty sure the vast majority of modern Mormons are not polygamists.
Also, if Matt Stone and Trey Parker seems to think that Mormons are alright, then they're probably alright.
Yeah.
What the fuck?! You see that shit?!
Yeah.
Fuck you, game!
I don't know why you went back, but okay.
I was trying to get on guard! On guard's an extra hit. Like... Yeah,
he would have come back to you. On guard doesn't despawn.
Oh, well, I was trying to wait for him, but then those fucking tires...
You were going into danger.
Shut up!
Okay, I'll shut up.
I was just trying to get my fucking fish, and you're giving me a hard time about it.
I made a polygamy joke around a girl whose parents turned out to be Mormon, and she got mad.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Don't tell me this was on, like, your bus job.
No. This was a Job Corps.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, man, that was a long time ago, then. She get mad enough to try to turn you into the fucking,
No.
Stab? No? That's good. That's good. Because considering how hardcore the staff are at Job Corps, they would have probably kicked you out and are...
No.
And that would have been a very different,
Fuck these piranhas.
On guard, you can come back anytime now! No!
I think he went through the level exit. He finished it without us.
Oh.
Yep. Bye! Oh,
bye.
Man, if I wanted to take him to the next level, too.
Well, there goes Poison Pond.
Minecart?
We haven't spoken to Cranky once.
Donkey Kong is just like, holy fuck, that minecart was heavy. I'm not lifting that thing again. This time we're jumping out of it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, this is the second variation.
With secrets.
Did they do this in the second game as well?
I think they did. I think they had one of each type of minecart level. Only they weren't minecarts. They were roller coasters.
Yeah. Those levels were very interesting. As much as I don't like minecart stuff because I'm not good at them, I will say that that those levels are still pretty fun with like the racing mechanic and stuff, and also the music for both variants.
Yeah.
Like the first one had the really cool like electro music, and then the second variant was that random ass classical music. All right.
You like? Oh right, there was the one. Yeah, the one where you're running from the ghost. That was a good track. Jump. Oh. Good save.
Yeah, good save. We didn't hit the checkpoint, did we?
We did.
Okay.
I don't know if we missed a secret. I know there's that lower track there, but I don't know if there are any like secrets that count towards completion.
Probably not.
Down there. On. Oh, come on.
Hey, just... There you go. Alright, tip 3.
I successfully prevented myself from succeeding.
You can always count on Space General to succeed to succeed. Actual line. Yeah, that was like a line where it's like... Which was actually kind of impressive if you thought about it. It was like, he can always succeed to succeed.
It's lonely to be alone. Even well, electronic brain crystal elderly pancake. Just a collect.
How come I can't get busted translations like that when I try to make bad scripts?
We got to one time on stream just get that collection of images and show them in sequence. So it's just a collection of terrible subtitles in anime.
Fuck, that was close.
I'm just listening in the background and all I notice are balloons popping.
That's our lives going.
I think that was the joke. Oh, you're gonna want to jump off somewhere? Never.
Ah!
No, you can't jump off. You're gonna have to wait till the end.
Oh, wait till the end.
And then you can jump back across the track. Sorry, I was thinking on my feet.
Yeah, you were. That's fine.
I'm surprised you managed to, somehow it's looked like you managed to jump out of the minecart in the previous level. And I wonder if you could have, like, landed on the platform.
Well, because when you get hit, you just kind of fly, it goes to, like, iframes, but the iframes don't, like...
They're not stuck to the cart.
Yeah, so you kind of go out of, like, you kind of just, like, have to jump back into the cart.
Yeah, so I wonder if you could...
Once you fly off.
I wonder if you could hypothetically land on the dirt platforms. I've never tried, I don't think.
I don't know, maybe? Would that be a speedrunning strat if you could?
No, it wouldn't be useful at all. We already got that one.
Yeah, you're right.
We just need the end level one, unless we missed one earlier.
A TK barrel would be really helpful right about now.
Yeah, they're kind of scarce.
Well, yeah.
Probably because they're so valuable in these levels.
Well, yeah, don't want to make it too easy for the player.
Oh, that one's a pacifist. He's not even doing anything.
Damn it!
And this also works out because you prefer Dixie in number two, right?
Yeah, because you can fly.
Yeah.
And
I'm all about maneuverability. I like the tight, precise Diddy controls.
Well, it's not like she's not precise. It's just that she's also necessary to get some,
She's definitely necessary. Fuck. She's definitely necessary.
That was a flaccid jump.
I just don't like how, like, her spin attack has a wind-up to it.
Yeah. Well, then again... How the fuck did I manage that?
Good start from Jack. And just other things that make her feel a little slower than Diddy to me. Small, like, couple frame differences.
I mainly jump on enemies in DK games, so yeah. It's not really too big of a deal for me.
And also the reason I like Diddy more than Donkey in this one, despite the, you know, weaker hitting...
Because he's faster.
Yeah, he's faster and he has a smaller hitbox, so he's kind of, in that way he's kind of safer.
Yeah. That's probably why I'm getting killed a lot, because I got the guy with the bigger hitbox.
I'm willing to... Wait, what do, did the speedrunners you saw have any real preference between the combos?
I think at certain points they're like, oh, we need this guy for this one, or this guy for this one.
Yeah, so just pretty
Especially
even.
In the second game, they said at multiple points, well, we need Dixie.
Well, yeah, same
They game. Actually, the reason why... There was a reason why they preferred Dixie to Diddy for speedrunners in that game, because Dixie has a shorter, like, win animation whenever they complete the level.
Yeah.
Especially for bosses, because usually for speedrunners, rather than like hit the target like at full force to get the item, they would just kind of hit it because that's the fastest.
I was specifically talking about one though, not two or any of the others.
Oh, shit! I haven't seen a speedrunner one in a while. I have to double check that, because I don't know if they, because I watch the AGDQ stuff more than like. Normal stuff, because they tend to explain stuff in AGDQ.
Yeah.
Whereas with normal speedrunners, they just kind of don't.
They have commentators with AGDQ, right?
Yeah, they do. They do. They have, like, a guy on a couch and the guy playing the game. Sometimes the guy playing the game plays the game, like, explains the speedrun. Sometimes, the guys on the couch just do it. Alright! Let's go back.
Oh, screw you. What's the beaver's role in this animal alliance? Are they just there?
They're
the Goombas, obviously.
They're just taking advantage of the situation to gather as much wood as they can.
Yeah. Beavers and snakes are the outliers.
The snakes. It seems like the conjurers could play Barrel and Drew Snake there.
Oh.
Seriously?
So if you want to, when it comes to your turn, you can go on to another level. I don't care. I'll do this one.
Alright. You know which one it is, then.
I assume it has to be before the checkpoint, like where that lower track was.
I'm working on it.
You don't need to look everything. You're such a quitter when it comes to looking stuff up.
Well, okay, here's the thing about me. I have no idea where to begin.
Okay, well, I'd like to try a little bit looking
Fine,
before
I've,
you
I've dropped the
get
phone!
On.
I've dropped the phone. I'm not... There you go. You found it.
Well, it was...
No,
I don't know if that
else.
Counted as a secret because it wasn't a barrel.
No, it needs to be a
okay,
barrel.
I don't know. You can look it up.
Oh, and I'm the quitter?
Well, I said, I want to try looking first. I want to try where I do know where to look. And did look there, and it wasn't there, so now I don't know.
Okay, going to the next one. Okay, that's not what I'm looking for. Minecart Madness.
to swap it to me?
Yeah. Yeah, I'll swap it to you.
Oh, I guess you can't when you're in the level, though.
Beginning. Okay, dodge two neckies, ride downwards, jump off, grab to the long rope. Do we grab to a rope at any of the secrets?
No.
Then we'll need to complete the level and go to the, back to the very beginning.
Alright.
My carts aren't nothing to fuck with.
Yeah.
Alrighty. What's a game with like the worst saving system? Besides the Bug's Life.
Like, there's one that I know I remember that I can think of, but I can't remember what that game was. I remember there was a very shitty save system somewhere. And I'm not gonna say Majora's Mask.
No.
Even though it was troubling at some times, but...
That's a save system that actively fucked us one time when we were playing it.
Yeah, it did. It was nice of them to provide the owl statues. I didn't even know you could use the owl statues until, like, my third playthrough. Still you.
Yeah, when they work, they work. When they don't...
Well, they only don't work if something happens to your cartridge. Like, you pull it out while it's
all right.
Playing
so,
or something.
They said near the K, so I'm gonna memorize this. In the level, grab the K, dodge two neckies, ride downwards, jump up and grab to the lone rope. Alright. So I'm guessing, like, there's gonna be a downward slope after the K, then you just make a leap of faith.
I think it's going to be a very barely visible rope.
Alright. Two neckies. Okay.
Up there.
There we go! Yes!
No, we got. I thought we got that one. Okay, go ahead. No, I guess not. How did we miss that?
Wait. Hold on.
Was that it?
Do you have to jump randomly? In the center of the track with bananas, jump up!
Okay.
That's what we're missing!
Gonna have to die. No, we still didn't go up there, I don't think.
No, we need to jump and hit...
I know, but we didn't go up there the first time. Like, we missed that rope completely.
Alright. How could we? It's very visible.
I know.
It's kind of... that. The both of us deserve a black eye for that one.
Yeah.
Okay. So...
Jump!
There we go.
Did we?
Oh, is whatever. It this one or another one we missed?
I guess we'll find out. Exit level.
Okay,
no, we're
it.
Just blind.
Alright, Blackout Basement.
Your favorite.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, this one. This one is, whoa. That was weird.
Why?
I just held Y and you just kept rolling.
Yeah, they do that on slopes.
That's cool. Yeah, I don't know where all the secrets are. You're gonna have to, direct me.
Alright. Keep going.
I hope there's no leap of faiths I have to make.
Hope not, too. I know there's gonna be a Rambi on this level. I remember that.
Wait, is that the...
I don't know. I don't think there's something below it. There might be, but let's wait until
we
get to the end and confirm.
Alright.
That'll be our place to look if we are still missing something.
Fuck. Yeah, this level sucks. I mean, from a design standpoint, it's pretty good. I just don't like it because of the fucking...
Yeah.
Alright, yeah, is there anything that...
Just keep going, I'll let you know.
Music's pretty good.
Yeah, I like this track.
Alright.
Can you imagine if this game didn't have saves and you had to go through it in one run like Mario 3?
That would suck.
Yeah, it would.
Go. Mistimed. I was doing pretty well, too.
Yeah.
I guess it's a good thing we hit that barrel. So I have a question for you.
Damn it, too far. Yeah?
Since it's March Madness and all, you did basketball. You know Shaquille O'Neal, right?
Yeah.
Really tall guy. Apparently has a really terrible free throw percentage.
Okay.
Which is kind of you know, they are, right? You stand in the center of the court and you just throw a basketball through the hoop.
Yeah.
So I have to wonder, how can a guy as tall as Shaquille O'Neal fuck up that many free throws?
Well, how would height help with that?
You don't have to expend as much effort to, like, get to the fucking...
Height's more about dunking.
I guess.
And just reaching the hoop more easily. If you're far from the hoop and making a just pure aim throw, it's not really relevant.
The fact that you've been deathly silent throughout this entire level means you probably have no idea where any of the secrets are.
No, I'm focusing. I'm watching carefully for secrets. My secret detector is on maximum setting.
So you really don't know?
I mean, not immediately. I never know until I see them. I know there's going to be a Rambi later, and there might be a bullshit one involving that Rambi, but we'll see.
Sorry, I got a pain in my neck right now.
Yeah. All right. Balloon pops. Thank you for your support.
Yeah, thank you. We.
Oh, he said that after the my secret detector.
It seemed like that would be one.
I don't know. A bunch of bananas usually isn't. And I didn't see any. I actually let myself go below the screen a little, and nothing happened. So. Okay. Fix the damn lights!
Wait, that's it.
Yeah, that's the one. I know that one. Nope, I'm done. I got what I need.
Not fucking around with that shit. Whoa. Kegger. Maybe he's useful for something. Oh, God!
Yeah!
the lights are fucking up!
Okay, they let us see the important part.
Yeah. That's two, right? But you're thinking there's a Rambi thing there, right?
I thought. Maybe I was just thinking of the previous level. Because I had a Rambi.
Well, let's get to the exit and find out.
Okay.
Oh, we got. Thank you. Thank God we don't have to go through that level longer than necessary. Alright, good luck with this one.
This is the one where I have a distinct disadvantage against Donkey.
Alright. Because you're not a good.
Fuck. Well, because the armadillos appear, and also the guys that I can only roll into to kill.
Dude, you fucking snakes!
Always with the snakes.
They don't have an obvious hitbox.
I guess I shouldn't say anything. I got beaten by the crocodiles.
Yeah. I got beaten by a higher tier enemy, according to this dude.
Because of their tricky hitboxes. I keep thinking this is one of those guys that stomps the ground and then you get paralyzed like in Mario 3, but it's not.
Yeah.
God, Mario 3 would have benefited so much from being able to save.
Yeah. You do it all at once or nothing, or not at all.
The good old NES days. You got 8 hours to kill on a whole, like, weekend? Mario 3.
Marathon. That's why they had the fucking...
Fuck these guys.
Alright, I got it.
Up to Donkey. Smash!
Yeah! I did it! It was all me! Alright, so we got 10 minutes to 70.
Does it say if we get... Go up. Does it say if we 100% of the worlds? No, it doesn't.
It doesn't.
Okay, I was just curious.
Well, it's pretty obvious.
Yeah, we get 10 minutes. We can take the hardest world in 10 minutes. It'll be great. Tanked up trouble.
There's trouble.
Fuel tank. Best level.
This is where the game starts really going out of its way to troll us.
I think this is, in my opinion, the worst, most unfun level in the game. So once we get past this, it's all uphill.
Good. gimmick's fine.
What do you think is the blackout level?
Blackout level is the most annoying one because it's just like, it's not even like, there's no way to really mitigate that.
Artificial difficulty.
It's not like it's artificial difficulty. It's just hard for the sake of being hard rather than hard for the sake of, I don't know. I'm not fucking around with it. There we go. This one is similar to the fucking timer level in Donkey Kong Country 2.
Yeah.
The one with the ghosts and all. Damn it. So.
If you run out of fuel and that falls, even if you're on a safe platform like these, you instantly lose. And Diddy just, like, throws his hat and gets angry. And
oh.
Lose a life.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That makes sense. Because you'd be stuck anyway. Yeah. So.
They spare you the experience of having to take your own life. Or they at least don't show that part on camera.
Yeah, so, that's why, because it's like, I look at this and I'm like, oh, it's like that timer level, so, it's not really that bad.
I think that one was more forgiving, though.
Think so?
Yeah. This one gets nasty towards the end.
Oh, yeah. But that one also had, like, minus barrels, too, so.
It did.
If at all possible, I don't want to play this level.
Yes.
Go for it. There we go. Wait, how? How?
I think I was supposed to have a tire, maybe? Well, whatever.
Did you need that for anything?
No.
So that better not be like a secret thing. Why have it then? Is that like just like
taunt you?
Is that like aesthetics or something?
Oh, look how much fuel you could be getting. Oh, it's okay though. The track's about to end. We were just messing with you. We're just having one of those rare japes.
Jungle japes. Fuck!
I thought there might have been a secret related to that spot, but I guess not. But the tire is now a liability.
We'll worry about secrets when
we have to come back and do the whole level over again.
Yeah. What the fuck? Oh. Well, that's just tech.
Yeah, just bananas.
No! No! I forgot about this!
Perpetual good luck.
Hey, cool.
Duck. Or don't. Jump. That works too, yeah.
That would've worked if I, you know. I should have ducked, because then I wouldn't have to try to angle myself back in position.
But the bananas.
But the bananas indeed. We haven't found a single fucking secret yet.
Nope. There's probably just going to be one, like, at the end of the level.
Imagine if they put four, like, five secrets in this level of
fuck
all places.
Fuck us, right?
You 100%, you better earn it, you schlubs! I'm having fun playing this game. This game's fun. Despite the dick stuff that it can do, it's actually really, it just plays really well, so it's forgivable.
What do you think is the, like, one of the hardest games to 100 complete, but still reasonably able to do so?
Nier.
Nier?
Yeah, for PS2. It's the same guys who made Dragon Guard, and their policy on completionism is that if you're a completionist, we hate you, so they intentionally design their games to be as hard to complete as possible. Like, 100%. So, you had a side quest in Nier called, like, Life in the Sands, I believe. And it was like, you had to do, like, a farming side quest to get, like, a certain kind of plant. And fuck me, that was, like, the hardest.
Oh, there's a secret.
Oh, really? Or no, it's not. It's just, fuck you, you get...
Go back.
Go back?!
Yeah. Look around.
I don't see anything. Yeah! Go back!
I'm sorry, I should have adjusted for your incompetence.
Shut up!
Well, they wouldn't have had that barrel there unless there was something we were missing.
I'm guessing it's like, that'll give you a reprieve, you just want to complete the level. But if you want to get a secret, you gotta...
You have far too much faith in humanity.
What?! Do you know who you're talking to?
There is a reason that was put there. I did not know it.
Far too much faith in humanity or far too much faith in the Rare Team level design?
I'm gonna solve this mystery today on Ghost Hunters.
Paranormal Hunter Ghosts.
They did it, Rooster Teeth did an animation where I guess Michael Jones was talking about he was talking about one of those Ghost Hunter-like shows, except this one is about some group who's just all obsessed with finding Bigfoot.
Oh, Bigfoot Hunters?
No. It was some obscure show that someone had told him about or something.
How can he? I said they're hunting Bigfoot. Oh, Bigfoot Hunters? No.
Like a show named Bigfoot Hunters, I thought you meant.
Oh, like people who hunt Bigfoot. Just
right,
like,
yeah.
Something like that.
And every time they run into something, they say, oh, it was Bigfoot! Bigfoot was there! Okay, it was just the letter G.
Yeah.
Not Bigfoot, just the letter G.
Yeah. So, no secrets.
I'm not gonna say that yet.
Well, no secrets we've gotten today.
I feel like they would put something down there. Do we risk it, or do we just go?
Just go.
We're gonna have to do the whole level over again.
Yeah.
It's not there.
Fuck it.
Otherwise, we'll restart from the checkpoint.
If you want to, Xelrog! Sorry! Sorry, Babby!
It was a calculated risk.
Are you sure? We may need to repeat the level over again.
I'd rather repeat half the level than the whole level.
We're gonna need to repeat the whole level, because I'm pretty sure there are some secrets in the very beginning.
Think so?
Yeah. I know so!
Okay. Well, at least
you
now...
You say I have too much faith in humanity?
At least now...
If I had a lot of faith in humanity, I would assume they wouldn't have done bullshit tactics.
We now know what the barrel's there for. It's a shortcut so you can skip the G. The G was the reward for the hard route.
Yeah.
So we can take the barrel. Just kill yourself. Most fun level design!
Yeah, you're right. This level sucks. You're right, the other one was more forgiving. It also had better music.
Yeah. I like this track. They both have good music. But
I like the track that directly sampled fucking, what was it? It wasn't Night on Bald Mountain.
I think it was Night on Bald Mountain. I think that was part of the, I think that was part of the Ghost Chase track.
No, it was Night on Bald Mountain, yeah. They sampled Night on Bald Mountain to make their Ghost Chase track.
Yeah.
I confused Night on Bald Mountain with Hall of the Mountain King. Because they both have Mountain in the title.
Oh, yeah, I know what you're talking about.
And both are really good classical tracks.
You didn't even need the barrels, you can just jump to get those bananas. That wouldn't have been quite as epic a chase.
Maybe it's the track starts with like the minecarts / roller coasters, and it slowly starts, and then the second part of the track kicks in when the ghost appears, and it's just the.
Can you imagine Donkey Kong Country with dynamic music? That'd be an undertaking.
Level on Donkey Kong 2 actually had dynamic music. There's like one part where it was like normal, and then you got to a certain point where the bee's chasing you.
Yeah, we're
and
missing
that's
stuff.
When the fucking we're missing a bunch of stuff.
We're missing, see how many secrets we got. Just look it up.
Okay.
I can't be bothered with this level.
No, this level doesn't deserve it. Okay. Blackout basement. We're through that. Tanked up trouble. Notes, this level features a platform that is powered on fuel. Alright, Kong. First one, ride the platform at the beginning of the level until the platform makes its first 90-degree turn. When this happens, they should roll or cartwheel under the platform and fall below it. And that's the only one.
You fuckers.
That's the only one, so you got it.
Oh, look at the balloon. It's so pretty.
No,
I tried.
Oh no, we're under 50 lives for once.
The horror. We might die. For realsies.
It's dark in here, and we may die. Yeah, just the one, then. Manic...
A, wor- a world where extra lives are a thing and the rich have like a billion lives and the poor people only have like two.
that reminds me of that movie In Time where it's like time till your like your lifespan was currency.
Yeah. So Shinigami.
Well, no, like if you want to buy something, then they anyway. Xelrog has left.
When the time comes, Light, I will be the one to write your name in my notebook.
Sounds fair. Well, see ya. Alright, Rambi. Also, I think this is the one with the bullshit Rambi one.
Also, I'm William Dafoe now.
He sounded fine.
I know. I'm not saying he didn't.
I always think that everything you say about the new Death Note movie has like an edge of, oh, but it's not this.
Yeah. It's not that... I thought...
Ah! You came back! No!
He tricked you and then he died. He left. He's gone! Forever! I'll follow you to the end of the earth, Rambi!
I feel like we may need him.
Probably. Now, I thought about it and I don't have a problem with Black L or Light Turner. It's just, Light Turner brought back a lot of bad memories of the early days of dubbing when no one was allowed to have a Japanese name.
Yeah, that's Sakura Avalon. They didn't even want her to be Sakura in Cardcaptor Sakura, but the mouth movements matched, so they're like, fuck it, you're Sakura. Like, I can't imagine, like, her name is Sakura, you want to change your name to something else? Like, what?
Well, and you have Serena, and you have Joey Wheeler, and you have Ash Ketchum.
I mean, it's a well, because it's like, well...
If American... Luffy was Japanese, four kids would have renamed him, right?
If what?
If Luffy was Japanese, four kids would have renamed him, right?
Oh, yeah, totally.
Like they did Zolo?
Zolo!
Well, we don't want to get sued by the Zoro people.
The fox that is cunning and free. Well, they wouldn't get sued anyway, because that Zoro has two R's.
Yeah.
And that Zoro only has one, so that would have been fine.
Yeah. No, plus, he's Zolo.
He had the first name Roanoa, so it still would have been fine.
What was other Zoro's first name? Was he just Zoro?
That was his nickname.
That was an alias.
Because Zoro was fox in Spanish.
Oh. I was waiting for you to be back at the beginning. Of what? The what level? The
minecart. I guess the fuel tank level.
Yeah, that one. That's the one I was trying to say.
I guess he knew. I guess Sandy knew about that secret, and we didn't.
I can words. God damn it,
he's too
rhino
fat.
Platforming!
Rhino platforming. Was that rhino doing parkour?
Oh, that's cool! That's so cool!
Oh, that's awesome! That's really awesome! Did we see that story on stream?
I don't think it was on stream. You explained to me. I had seen that before, I just didn't remember where it was from.
Yeah, it was the one where,
Because I own season one of Metalocalypse, and that's from season
that's
two,
That's from
you
season
said.
Two. Oh, did Rambi go?
Yeah, he's gone. That was like...
What the fuck?
That's another one of those technically a secrets, but just because they want... Nope. Uh-uh. Just because they wanted a way, something to have you... Oh, their height changes. I see. We don't even need to go in there. Fuck that. Well, maybe we need to get together.
What? Yeah!
I guess it's just something to do on your way through, but it doesn't matter if you get hit because you go out the other side anyway. Fuck!
Grab the DK barrel.
Oh, we need a barrel. Doesn't matter what barrel.
Yeah, grab the DK barrel.
But what if we need the dynamite?
Ah, so needy!
What if it's an oil barrel? Oh, okay, it blows up after a time.
God, you're frustrating.
It's gonna... Fine.
Don't worry about it! No, I'm gonna worry about it! No, I'm telling you not to worry about it! No, I'm worrying about it!
Yeah. Well, what if it's an oil barrel? Well, you need TNT to blow those up.
Well, then you go back and get it! It's not like it'll be gone forever!
But, yeah, speedrun!
Stop your whining, you sniveling dog!
But, meow! All the other kids have Okama Game Spheres!
Do we get all the secrets in that level?
Yeah, we did.
Okay, good. Which one is this? What's the gimmick to this level?
Oil barrels, dropping shit.
Oh, that's all? Alrighty.
Barrels full of enemies. Barrels of fun!
Whatever. What?! That was a total...
So Matt Stone and Trey Parker totally just looked up the, They looked up gay in English to Japanese, and that's why they called it the Okama, right?
Oh, really? Is that...
That has to be what happened.
Okama Kimbo. Matsuda Trey Parker do research on targets.
I mean, it's not explicitly gay. It's more of a, like a specific sect of
it's
a
just,
culture.
It's just Japanese cross-dressing stuff.
But
it's
if
fun.
They looked it up in like an English to Japanese translator without all the context, that's what they would get.
Possibly. I don't know. What's the Japanese word for gay? I don't know. Okama? Wait, you mean they have a martial art based on that?
Well, in One Piece.
In One Piece.
Gay foo. Four kids would have had nothing to do with that if they got to that point in the series.
They probably would have just made them all women. Or something.
Could they get away with making Bon Clay a woman?
I don't know. I don't know. I'm glad 4Kids isn't touching that series anymore.
Like, they had no idea what they were eventually going to be getting into.
Like at some point, Funimation must have said to, like 4Kids, just like, do you have any idea what you're getting yourselves into?
Well, that far ahead of the series hadn't existed yet. They hadn't done those arcs.
Yeah.
God damn it. Where's the secret? I'm gonna waste all my TNT on these shits. There's
you got
it.
One,
right?
Right
down there.
That's it?
That was it. Maybe we can get a TNT back here.
DK barrel, but that's suspended.
It's gonna be a long trek if there is one. Oh, fuck you guys. Fuck you guys.
Good luck.
I'm gonna have to die.
Yeah, do it. You're not... Are you fucking serious?!
Oh, right, that doesn't kill me. Okay, you kill yourself and I'll give control to you.
God damn it, you... Wait, what the...
Wow!
Wow, I remember this glitch!
What fuckery is this?
Oh, yeah! Yeah, speedrunners do this all the time!
Well, don't exit the level. You still gotta kill yourself. I've not seen this before.
Oh my god!
So if you die and
speedrunners use this technique to, like, skip large sections of the level.
So if you die and land on an enemy, this happens?
Yeah, if you get hit, well, and then you land on an enemy...
Just waiting to land?
Yeah.
Is it gonna happen?
It'll happen eventually.
Are you sure?
I just complete the level. I can't complete the level in this state anyway, so...
I need to the moon.
To if I see...
Can you... Does pressing down help?
No, that's not gonna work.
Are we stuck?
No, we're not stuck. They'll come down eventually. You will. Wait!
I hear that. That's from Donkey Kong 2.
They used this part, and they put it into, like, part two.
They reused the riff. Oh, you got something.
No, I paused it.
Oh.
I was hoping I could start select out of there, but I guess it wasn't meant to be.
When did we last save?
I don't fucking know. No, we'll be fine. We just need to... He'll come down eventually. See?
Oh, there he is. He went to fucking orbit! Can you blame me?
I'm glad that's the first time I was able to that's how we just you were able to find out about that glitch.
He went in. He was up for like a solid minute.
See, this is how speedrunners discover strats accidentally.
Yeah.
And then they're like, "Oh, this could actually save a lot of time. Is there a way to reproduce it?" Yes. Well, fuck it. We'll do it. All right. So you need to get a barrel and then just drag it all the way. To like that pit, and then that's the...
No glitch speedruns are a thing, but those are like the most boring to watch.
No, I like glitches. Which is kind of strange because a lot of people are actually the opposite. They'd rather have speedrunners do it.
Oh, okay.
They actually want to see him do it like glitchless because it's like, oh, that's not... Using glitches isn't true speedrunning because they're cheating. And I'm like, no, they're not cheating.
That's kind of what speedrunning's all about, though.
Like, glitches are programmed into the game. Like, that's the way it is.
Well, and also, they're harder to do than just playing the game normally. In the vast majority of cases.
Yeah, it's closer,
it's more exciting to watch.
It's like those people complaining, like, oh, you're not playing real magic because you're using blue. Or like whatever ultra-powerful card or combination or something. It's like, it doesn't make any sense to me.
Yeah.
Like, I enjoy it when they show off glitches.
Alright. Missed something.
Yeah, we'll see what it is. Unless you're confident as to what it could be.
I'm not confident, but can you, like, switch to me so I can look around while you're looking it up at least?
Yeah, I'll do that. Yep.
I feel like, I think it's a barrel we have to blow up that gives access. I think I know where it is.
Okay. Not manic mincers.
Don't tell me until I've tried where I'm going first.
Fair enough. Notes, this level has a mist effect surrounding it.
Good advice. Good info. No, no.
Not there.
Oh! Ah!
At least you get to try again.
Oh no, there's ground under there. I thought there was a, I thought there was a barrel that fell into, so I
I just read something.
What?
Do you know there's a Game Boy Color port of this game?
Yep. I think I have it.
How would that play? I can't imagine that playing well.
It's okay, actually.
It is?
Yeah. Well, it doesn't look as nice, but
yeah,
it,
I imagine
it functions.
Not. Well, good on Rare for making a functional port. 25. 20.
It actually has,
15,
like, additional mini
10,
games and shit. Oh, this was too far. Yeah. Did I break it? Okay, there we go.
He gave you time to finish.
The very last frame.
Okay, so you got the...
Okay, tell me, internet. Oh, fuck. And it's back to you. What do you find?
It's immediately after the checkpoint.
Okay.
So, I got a while yet.
That's the first one in the levels after the checkpoint?
Yeah, immediately. Okay, this soundtrack is very fucking creepy.
Yeah.
Alright, go.
It's almost like you're in a real mine. It could collapse at any second.
It'll collapse at any second. We should just begin. Like, we shouldn't have wasted time eating and watching Jackie Chan Adventures.
That's okay. We'll make it.
Alright. So.
The latest this will go is 8 o'clock.
Okay.
We're through most of the levels at this point. We only have a couple more.
Okay, so there's a long rope after the star, the checkpoint, and then as you ride along it, climb downwards to the bottom of the area to find a cave, and that's where you're going.
I don't think we got the checkpoint yet.
It should be pretty obvious.
There it is. I think. No. There it is.
There it is. All right. So rope, go down. Keep going. There you go. That makes sense.
Sneaky devil. We could have found that one.
We could have.
But we didn't. Oh.
Cool. There are no letters. Are you serious?
You know, them mine ostriches and their native habitat. Oh, so that, I guess that's how you're supposed to get that thing?
I guess. That's all the secrets. So...
Loopy lights.
Oh, is this... Which one is this one? On. On. On.
It'll go off after too long, see?
Yeah. At least it's much better than that other fucking level. You missed.
I missed. But it was there.
I see it. I'll take it.
The point is it was there.
I see it. I'll take it. These fuckers. Ow. I missed everything. All right.
At least you
can fucking jump. That's not fair.
At least you can control these lights, and it's not just constantly flipping on and off.
Yeah. No, this level's much better in that regard.
Although it is basically the same thing as the last levels with these switches.
I feel like there's gonna be a leap of faith because this level seems like a very tall level. Oh shit. Oh, good.
Oh, no, never mind. I thought that was a barrel up there. It was a light.
Oh, I'm stumped. Ah, fuck. Well...
Bye.
Shit.
Oh, you fucker.
Okay, good. Going back?
Well, I wish I could have examined those, but yeah, it's too late.
Checkpoint.
That riff.
That riff.
It's so creepy.
That's a really good riff. Somebody acknowledged that that's a really good riff and they used it again.
It's so creepy without anything else behind it, though.
Yeah, not as fun. The soundtrack in the second game is less like creepy ambience and more fun.
Yeah, it is. This game's soundtrack is kind of haunting a lot of the time.
Yeah, and then the third game soundtrack is very chill. Very, like, just slow, moody stuff. Except for a couple.
Oh, goddammit.
Except for a couple tracks where it's, like, very boisterous. It follows!
I probably needed that barrel for one of those walls.
Probably. Wait. Is there something up there? No?
Didn't see anything.
They were like...
Oh, there's gonna be something here. There's gonna be a barrel that I have to go through these bees with.
Oh, really? You gotta get a barrel and trek back?
That's what I'm sensing. No? Guess no. Not.
Oh! Maybe. No. Good moves. Well, Xelrog, good moves. Keep it up, I'm proud of you.
There's still something. Well, at least we can save now.
Yeah, we can save. I'll let you try it, but I'll have it up just in case.
96%.
We're almost done. This is the final level.
I think it was at... Just look it up. I want to be sure that it's after the checkpoint, before I get the checkpoint.
Alright, so... Level's first pit.
We got that.
And then second one. Meet a Neki. Defeat the pump. Pick up a normal barrel under it. Carry it up to over to a small clap and pass a red clock trap into a small wall.
Okay, so yeah, it is that barrel.
Then blast it. Okay. So it is what you thought it was?
Yeah, that's right. One of the ones I thought it was.
Okay. Well, you thought correctly. So it's a barrel and then hit a wall with it.
It's the barrel under the Neki.
The one throwing nuts?
Yeah.
Okay. So take out the Neki first somehow and then... If you want, I can sacrifice myself so you can get, like, a higher ground on it. Like, I can take the hit and then you can use your iframes to just kill him.
Yeah, maybe.
It's less risky than the alternative. Or you can just grab that. Fuck, this game's music is so creepy. There goes that barrel.
Yeah, he's up here. Yeah, he's too high to do anything else.
Ah! Ah!
Hit me!
Okay,
hit
me!
Oh, okay, that works too. Just leave him.
Oh shit, it's dark. Wait, don't.
Need to see!
I guess if you have this level memorized, you don't really need to. He's moonwalking. There we go.
I also didn't know that you could set barrels down until, like, my third playthrough of this.
It's a very handy trick.
Yeah. Oh, god damn!
No! Well, it doesn't matter. We're done with the level anyway, so.
Can we start select out of this, please?
No.
God damn it. No! You're gonna play the game, and you're gonna like it. You're gonna get the full experience of fun! Are you having fun?!
Was that also from South Park?
No.
Damn it, it sounds like it should have been!
Like, it's just me giving game design, like...
God!
Like, what they must be thinking when you have an aspect of the game that you can't quit out of.
Well, it's like, they're thinking, oh, it's a bonus, they're gonna love this. But they didn't realize, like, years later that we grow tired of, like, getting all these extra lives, and then, like, we want to skip out of it, and they didn't think of that.
But a Bappy game is too easy.
We say that, but we're really sucking at this final part.
Yeah, even so, we're nowhere near getting a game over, though.
Yeah. That's a good thing.
I'll just wait here. Can I put my hole in the ground? Is that a move?
Put a hole in the ground?
No, like my head in a hole.
Oh.
Is there a swear button?
Fuck! you motherfucker!
Polly want a bitch!
Polly want a bitch.
So that was it, right?
Yeah, that's it. That's only two.
Okay.
Let's see it again.
So I think this is the last level.
Last level. And what's it called?
Wow.
So, four secrets.
I think it's the one where it has a lot of falling platforms.
Platform perils, yeah.
You wanna go for it?
Sure. Oh, and there's a secret already!
Let me see if I can get that first. Oh, I remember this one. This is a dick one.
How you do it?
Not like that.
What the fuck are you thinking?
There's a hidden platform somewhere just below the bottom that you have to ride left to that barrel.
Oh no, I have to do random jumping?
Maybe you roll over to the right to it?
Alright, fine.
Maybe it's straight down? Oh no, the camera moves there, so it can't be over there.
This could be difficult. Or maybe roll to the left when you get there? No.
Where the fuck is it?
You see, this is where I draw the line when I'm having to do random fucking guessing.
Yeah.
I'm looking it up. Knowing is half the battle. I don't want to have to
guess. Well, I want to be doing something while you're looking that up.
Fair enough. Do your thing.
Where's your select button?
There it is. Back. There you go.
Found it.
Oh.
Immediately under.
Jeez. Yeah.
Don't care.
There's another one, by the way.
Okay,
so.
We'll find it. Maybe. We'll see if we can find it. Unless you already
naughty. That's all I know. It has to do with the naughty. Like one of those beavers.
The beavers, yeah.
Yeah. Nice!
You wanna try?
Sure.
You haven't played in a little while. Hope you didn't need that barrel.
Hope I didn't either.
Oh, I think I remember the one.
Oh, okay.
So it'll be a dick one.
Does it have to do with the naughty?
Yeah.
Alright.
There's like a naughty on a very high platform that you have to get to or something.
Okay. So when we see the dick laughing at us, we get to him and we kick his ass. Like the hillbilly monkeys we are.
Oh god, nope. Go away.
We're experts at this game. We look up the fucking secrets. Rather, I am. You tried to stop me, but then you're like, yeah.
Well, there are some instances where I will allow it. You now have my permission to cheat. Did you, was there something down there? I thought I saw something.
No. Does it have anything to do with the naughty? No. Then.
We just got the checkpoint. If it wasn't right there, I wouldn't have done it.
Alright. Oh, it kills.
Fuck you, B.
The act of respawning kills a bee.
You never told your redneck car story on the stream.
Oh, I don't want to.
Okay.
I've made my peace with that guy. I don't want to sling mud on it.
Sleeping dogs lie.
Let sleeping dogs lie. Because at the end of the day, he gave my company business, and you know what? I'm not gonna fuck with that. But long story short, I got lost. And that's all. I got lost, I made a wrong turn, and that's all I'll say on the matter.
In the wrong neighborhood, and that's all you'll say.
You're in the wrong neighborhood, pal.
Look if there's a banana under this last naughty. No, that's not a secret, that's just a banana.
I'll get it anyway.
The gray ones are too strong even for Kong.
The steroids.
Okay.
Oh! Okay, then!
Convenient that he'll deal with himself for us. The barrel fucked you.
Yeah, it fucked me. Go on.
Too many barrels. The barrels are the real obstacle.
I'll give you another hint. Very last platform of the level.
Okay. The Angry Beavers, but it's about two beavers from this game.
These fucking monkeys are kicking our ass, we gotta stop them!
I don't even know why, I'm just trying to live my life, wandering a platform, minding my own business.
They're casualties of war. They're like,
I never wanted to be involved in this, monkey crocodile war. This is not my war.
Florida versus Cuba, the Canadian revolt.
Two pops.
Love it if our streamer audience didn't actively antagonize us, but you know what? We'd suck, so what you gonna do?
That's just part of the streamer experience, Jack.
I guess people give Vinny a lot of shit, too. At very least, we don't have anybody on stream yelling at us that we're not playing the game correctly like a bunch of people did with Undertale.
Yeah. I would've found that.
Yeah, you would've. That's why I didn't actively say it, I just gave you hints. Like, I like it when there's bananas that signify there's something going, like, there.
Yeah.
Not when there's just fucking nothing and you gotta take a blind guess.
That's the difficulty, though. You gotta jump into every part of every abyss of every level. It's fun, right?
No, it's not fun. This game is truly perfect, but that sucks.
Yeah.
100%!
Oh, we're done, right? Stream over, guys!
Stream over!
Let's go home! That was Donkey Kong
Country!
King
Rule what?! Necky's Revenge.
So they ran out of ideas, right?
Reskinning bosses? Yeah. Look! They reused the same fucking background, too! So, if Ed Wood... Not Ed Wood...
If Ed Wood, what
George
would he
Wood, do? That's his name. Not Ed Wood. He didn't review games, he made bad movies. If George Wood, found Donkey Kong Country 2, do you think he would have been like, I thought it was perfect, but this is better if you don't like this game, and your mom's a whore.
And then he sees Donkey Kong 3, and he's like, eh, it was alright.
I know you don't like that
I'm
game!
I'm just messing.
But come on! I have fond memories of that game, because I played the first two games like, oh, those are fun. My grandmother, my sweet dead grandmother, brought home the third one.
Oh, initiating
the feels. When me and my mom and my brother were still living with her, and I was just giddy that there was a third one. And it played all right.
Yeah.
I don't know why you decide you're going to give that one so much shit.
And then Donkey Kong 64. Do you want to try first?
Yeah, I'll try it first.
This is way too happy music for a boss fight, by the way.
It's pirate shit. Come along aboard the crew wall. Drink Binx's brew. Or whatever that's.
Yeah, that was close enough.
And then. No, you're not done yet.
Cannonballs!
No, he's jumping. I don't know what's going on. Oh shit!
Cannonballs!
you got an AC-130 just dropping bombshells on you, K-Rool. You might want to deal with that.
Duck and cover! I like how Diddy just kind of half ducks. He just does one arm down. Eh.
Yeah.
Doesn't cover his head or anything.
This is foreshadowing the next game, I feel.
Bonk! It's always jumping on heads. This is one of the few places they used a electric guitar MIDI sound in this game.
Yeah, it's really nice too.
I did it! Yay!
Yay.
The end. We're done. That was Donkey Kong, folks. We can all go home now.
No, it's the
coding claptrap. Characters credit. Well, there's something weird about these credits.
You think Shang Tsung has taken over the credits? The end. I think they just turned the game off at this point.
Microsoft Sam was in the credits to Wall-E. Was it Microsoft Sam?
It was some like Texas speech thing.
Yeah, as it voices the main villain.
Yeah. Didn't you take this guy out?
Yeah. Well, that's why I figured is that I'd probably do it in one try, so I wanted to give you a shot.
Yeah, shot for me to show you up. Unfortunately, And then third jump pattern.
What?
Little hops, little tiny hops.
Bunny hop.
This'll surely get him.
What does King K. Rool sound like? I don't even know.
Oh, like that.
Oh!
Yeah. He was in the cartoon, I guess, but I never watched the cartoon.
No, neither did I.
Haven't heard good things about it.
Nope. Well done.
Who'd have thought a young whippersnapper like you?
Like me.
Could have beaten that bunch of no-good kremlings.
You made me proud. Proud. Hits him with a cane.
Go and look in your hold. I think you'll be in for a surprise. Cranky
is surprisingly large compared to Donkey.
Yeah.
He's actually a little bit bigger.
Yeah.
Which makes sense given how big original OG Donkey Kong was. Spoiler, that was Cranky.
Yeah.
You found absolutely everything. You're nearly as good as I used to be.
Yeah, we got the banana horde back.
Oh, Sandy sent us a YouTube video. Go see Gramps.
And so ends our tale of... We managed to do it in one stream.
Sandy, is this footage of the Donkey Kong cartoon?
We don't want to see footage of the Donkey Kong cartoon. Army! Not just Army!
I'll play it if it is.
Zinger!
Four separate color schemes.
Slippa.
Fuck you, Slippa.
Manky.
He's just... What is he doing?
Oh, he's from Manchester. Manky Kong.
What? You're pausing it? Okay.
I'm gonna play the audio.
Alright.
It's probably King K. Rool's voice. Let's hear him.
Kids, there's nothing. Alright.
Pirate Scorn.
Okay.
Okay, where's voice?
Okay, maybe there?
Hello? Internet.
You're streaming.
Once a fearsome pirate ruled the seven seas, he was your great, great, great grand happy Prince Kirby.
I don't think that's
no, thank you.
So meanwhile,
so he's just generic pirate. Good to know. The aquatic bad guys.
Is that actually in the show, or was that just some video someone made on YouTube? Croctopus. Chomps Jr.
Hey, Chomps. The fatter one.
Clambo.
But...
Squidge. Good name.
Okay, that was pretty good.
I like it when games have a sense of humor. In the credits.
The game should be fun.
Play around with the... No, it's the actual movie. His voice is in it. Lol. There was a movie of the show?
Wait, that was...
I just know there was the cartoon that was like 20-minute episodes.
Yeah, and they used the same 3D animation studio that they did for Reboot, it seems like.
There's a Captain Underpants movie coming out.
You told me this.
I watched the trailer.
How was it?
Looking back on it, I remember how goofy a premise Captain Underpants is.
Yeah.
But, I mean, And also, the voices sound really weird, like, not at all what I would expect for the characters, but... I don't know. I may or may not give it a shot. It's actually DreamWorks.
DreamWorks?
Like, the main body of DreamWorks. The guys who did Shrek.
Oh! Okay, then!
So, they're...
Sure.
I guess they're putting their all into Captain Underpants.
We don't want to fuck this up or we'll never hear the end of it.
I think Kevin Hart is the black kid. Like, when I picture the two kids' voices, I picture, like, Arnold and Gerald from Hey Arnold.
Yeah.
But they sound like 30-year-old dudes.
Well, should have gotten...
Is it my turn yet?
Funky Kong. There was a Donkey Kong movie, Crystal Coconuts. Sounds about on par with the Crystal Skull.
Cranky Kong.
Diddy Kong.
And finally, Donkey Kong.
Donkey Kong.
Yeah.
I'm the best!
Yay!
Swanky Kong.
What? Look. Ah, no!
Kong Family Sect is the best!
Rules the world! Always
with old. Bananas. What a
they're
shitty
fucking
thing.
With each other.
What a shitty thing to hoard. The more you have, the faster they go bad, Donkey, you idiot.
Those are magic bananas.
Oh yeah, they're made of solid gold, I remember. I did this using one life.
You're a liar, Cranky.
And it took me less than an hour.
what, 100%ing it? Because that's actually impossible.
Yeah.
Unless you use tool-assisted speedruns. Kiefer Sutherland.
I'm sure you could
Bart,
get
to, Billy Gunn.
You could get to the end of the game in one life in under an hour, though.
Probably. Yeah, you could totally, like, just do a
the friction is real.
Friction? A Smith? Graphics manipulation. So is that like
what the fuck is that?
Is that the person who hand molded the clay figures? Probably. Is that graphic manipulation?
Graphics manipulation. You don't want to just do like model animator or something?
I'm not a janitor. I'm a custodial engineer.
4, 5, 9 testers. Perfect.
With additional testing.
Yeah, you gotta have as many testers as you can to make sure your game is up to snuff.
Oh, someone did the manual. My Miss One games had manuals.
Yeah.
It was cool to read them and see all the funny little things.
Illusion of Gaia is like manual. Actually, has like a walkthrough for the entire game, so yeah. That's pretty nice.
Mr. Yamauchi, not Yamaguchi.
Special thanks, Mr. Yamauchi-san.
K-Lob. Alias, Nintendo, and Rare ACM. Whoever Alias is. Silicon Graphics.
Yeah, that's the guys who did the whole thing, I guess. The graphics.
Miyamoto, God bless.
Yeah.
That's not even full names, it's just S. Miyamoto.
Yep.
No one cared about video game designers at this point in history.
No, nobody gave a shit, which is kind of tragic.
Yeah.
Presented by Nintendo.
So I don't
That was abrupt.
At least it's not an infinite ending.
No.
So I don't know about you, but I'm off to look up candy porn.
Shut up. Of course you are. Well, that actually turned out pretty well.
That was Donkey Kong Country.
The highlights will be interesting to do.
Where's my mouse? My mouse is gone. It's vanished.
Can't escape. You'll get your mouse back.
Oh, it's window locked.
Yep.
No, my mouse is still gone.
No, just click outside.
There it is. Okay.
All right. Well, we'll see you guys next time.
We went for 3.5 hours.
3.5? Not our longest. Our longest is still Sonic.
Still Sonic.
And mostly it was because of that boss.
Yeah. All right. So that was Donkey Kong Country. We'll get to the second one eventually.
Eventually. But first we gotta finish Pokemon/Lagoon.
See you later, guys.
See ya.